the danger of such beauty. Because if you touch it, ये हमारी जम के लेने वाला है.
One samosa caucus where he's gonna have a field day.
Yeah, he is. I am the only one that has been to jail. Jail में बिरयानी मिलता है.
They put me in the lockup.
You're too pretty to be in the lockup.
That's what happens. You have all these.
क्या था वो slogan क्या था?
हाथ बदलेगा हालात.
हाथ बदलेगा. ये हाथ हालात बदलने के लिए.
ये हाथ मुझे दे दे अभिजीत.
दूसरा हाथ बदलेगा हालात.
Waqf Act will continue, Place of Worship Act will continue, temples will remain under state control, RT Act will continue. Everything that Hindus want for India to prosper in the long run is out of the
Give
window.
This was the first election where Rahul Gandhi wasn't made a pappu out of. They turned him into Darth Vader. And you know, if anybody watches Star Wars here, I support right. Darth Vader.
Had they said, hum samvidhan mein sanshodhan karna chahte hain, it was one thing. Aap sanshodhan bolo aur aap bolo hum samvidhan ko badalna chahte hain. एक नया संविधान लाना चाहते हैं. दिस स्टार्टेड फिल्टरिंग डाउन
द हेट्रेड फॉर अजीत पवार एंड आई एम यूजिंग अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग वर्ड. ही इज वेरी पावरफुल. ही कंट्रोल्स ब्यूरोक्रेसी. इनफैक्ट इवन इन द एमबीए गवर्नमेंट एनी फाइल ओवर 1 crore अजीत पवार वुड साइन बिकॉज़ ही वाज फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर.
इसको डिफेमेशन का डर क्यों नहीं है?
मुझे कोई डर नहीं. कर रहे अजीत पवार मुझ पे
डिफेमेशन. ये खुद ही लोगों के ऊपर.
सुनो सुनो नाउ द थिंग इज सो
मतलब हम जैसे लोग ही जेल जाएं. बच जाता है यार ये.
Namaste, Jai Hind. You're watching or listening to another edition of the ANI podcast with Smita Prakash. The mandate is out and NDA is set to form the government with Narendra Modi at the helm. But the victory wasn't really the landslide expected. The BJP didn't secure a majority on its own and will need to lean on its allies for the next 5 years. So what went wrong for the BJP? What worked in favor of the opposition? And what will this coalition government look like? In this episode, I have with me the real Samosa Caucus. So we have with us Tehseen Poonawala, political analyst, Anand Ranganathan, the author, scientist, Abhijit Iyer Mitra, defense expert and political ideology researcher, Sushant Sareen, senior fellow at ORF. They've been part of our lively discussions before in episode 125, 80 and 28. So by popular demand, the Samosa Caucus. Thank you. Thank you, Samosa Caucus, for coming back a couple of days after the results. Thank you very much. Gloating rights, Tehseen?
Gloating rights.
यार gloating right नहीं देखो ये जब exit poll वाला दिन था ना मैं इसको देख रहा था और ये
गंग हो
no, गंग हो ही नहीं मतलब कि it seemed कि यार ये क्या बोल रहा है ये आदमी result कुछ और दिखा रहे हैं ये बोलते जा रहा है कि 290 260 some weird figure he was giving and I knew कि ये podcast होने वाला है
ऐसा
ये आएगा
Tehseen ki.
But he's going to be taken, yeah. And because, you know, he was saying it so convincingly. I was wondering what's wrong with this guy.
No, he manifested it. I'm just confessed that Tehseen manifested these results.
This is the power of manifesting.
Yeh hamari jamke lene wala hai.
Nahi, yaar.
It's Tehseen.
But
he's like one samosa caucus where he's going to have a field day.
Yeah, he is.
But I manifested this.
You manifested.
देखो देखो ऐसे field day. यार देखो ऐसे है. सिस्टम इनका सरकार हमारी है. बात खत्म हो गई.
And that continues.
That continues.
ये लाइन रट के आया सुशांत.
नहीं नहीं मैं अभी मेरे को अभी सूझ आया.
सुशांत जी सडनली ज्ञान.
मैं कुछ और बोलने वाला था बट मैंने वो सोचा पॉलिटिकली बहुत इनकरेक्ट हो जाएगा तो यही वाले लाइन यार वो बहुत ज्यादा हो जाता बाद में बताऊंगा इसके.
पर आप समोसा कॉकस को थोड़ा रिक्रिशन कर दिया जाए थोड़ा सा कुछ.
आई नो वी आर ऑल ऑन डाइट्स राइट.
सो इडली कॉकस.
इडली
आई थिंक इडली कॉकस बट
भटूरा आई डोंट नहीं बट हमारी दोनों की लड़ाई हो जाएगी बिटवीन स्टीम्ड एंड
राहुल गांधी को क्या पसंद है खाना.
I thought he likes Italian. Yeah. No, I'm just joking.
No, he said I like dal chawal of Rai Bareli in that photo shoot that he did.
Dal chawal caucus
and he likes chicken tikka.
Which he had with that.
Remember curly tails?
Curly tails.
But he also had chole bhature. He went to Pandara Road or somewhere and had chole bhature.
So he's a foodie. We know Rahul Gandhi is a foodie.
I don't mind chole
bhature. Pandara Road, kaun chole bhature khata hai? Chole
bhature
khata hai Bengali market.
Bengali market. And Pandara Road, I think you get the butter chicken.
Yeah, butter chicken.
That's. And he had champaran mutton during the...
With Laluji.
With Laluji.
They barely cooked it.
And we are beginning with food. I just
because there is no food on the table.
Why?
No, let's imagine.
Can I just make? There is no can such thing as champaran mutton. Okay, it's called mutton ahuna, and this fad word is champaran mutton. So there is no such thing as champaran mutton. It is mutton ahuna.
Okay, so should we start about the
results.
What else is there?
And you know, most irritating are those people, those journalists who says, we saw it on the ground. Fir dash dash dash. Tum bole kyon nahi?
Dekh bhai.
Huh?
Let's be clear. Nobody saw it on the ground. My RA, I told you, went on telling me ki bhaiya kuch to ho raha hai.
What's RA?
RA. Research assistant.
Like.
You have a research assistant?
Like, can exact, I have an executive.
Fish, you have a research assistant?
Yes. And usne wo mere ko bol raha tha, kyunki uska khandan Rai Bareli mein, Amethi mein, ground pe kaam karta hai. He's saying, bhaiya, is baar to 40 seat jane wale hai. Main usko bola, chup, phat. ऐसे बकवास बंद कर, तू बेहोश है.
मैं भी था तेरे साथ.
तो you also.
We were both driving back from Jaipur. When he was talking about it.
Yeah.
And we both bullied him. We said, you don't know nothing.
Jaipur is like November
November.
But in the last month, he had crystallized it. A month before the election, he had crystallized it to kam se kam 40 seat jane wale.
Okay, about 3-4 days before the election results came out, I was at a friend's house who's a bureaucrat. And he was telling me some of his batchmates from UP had come, who in November last, when your guy was saying that this is the situation, those guys were saying BJP will win 81 out of 80. Okay, one second. Pura sun. He says in around March.
81 out of 80?
Sense of humor ko kya hua hai? Okay. But in March or April this year, he said the same guys said if they'll be lucky if they get 40. The same guys. So something has shifted drastically in about 4, 5, 6 months. And I think this is something they really need to look at very carefully.
Yeah, we don't know
whether
what.
It was.
Like, we know there was a non-Jatav Dalit revolt.
Yeah.
They shifted en masse of all people to the SP.
SP Congress.
And you know, the SP represents the caste that do the actual face of the oppression of the non-Jatav Dalits. So how it shifted there was truly remarkable.
Because the second built a coalition of enough Dalits.
You're talking about now all of UP, or are you talking only about Amethi?
Yeah, because no. All of UP. All of UP where BSP vote went down and it moved to SP Congress.
Which was, of all the transference to happen, I never saw that happening to SP of all parties. Okay? But the second thing that happened was, people aren't talking about this, there was also a Thakur boycott.
That's Rajput. True.
Right. Rajputs and Thakurs are the same thing. Yeah. Well, apparently this is the way it's explained to me. Once the Yadavs are in power, they want everything. Okay? And all of them are little Maharajas in their own right. The problem was here, even though the Thakurs had both Rajanath ji at the center and Yogi here and all the bureaucrats were Thakur, all the Thakur MLAs and MPs had zero agency. You could go to an MP, nothing would get done. You had to go to Yogi's Darbar and get it done. So all the Thakurs, see, they're all seen as community seats. They're not seen as
BJP seats or Congress seats.
So community has to give to community.
But
aren't we jumping the gun a little bit? Just to get to the point is that this whole Eastern UP belt, this is where all the expressways were built, so much of development work.
See, development, hum sab dekhte hain ki road bana hai, ye bana hai, all these corridors also. All the people who actually lived on those corridors got displaced, they got 2-3 lakh rupees. All the new guys who have come and bought the land have their crores. Land is appreciated 2-3 crores. Wo jo unka chuna aur pathar ka jo ghar tha, even that to make in this day and age costs about 12 lakhs. Yeah,
3 lakhs mein kya hoga?
2-3 lakhs mein kya hoga?
They should have
you pushed them out. Everybody else benefited from it. The actual people who left that area,
the stakeholders,
were completely destroyed. तो कहाँ से वोट करोगे?
Unlike
and
say
see,
Haryana.
Here you have ghettos.
Like,
you have
maybe go give enough time to each one.
Sure, yes,
than
absolutely.
Have. So I think this
so,
obvious.
So you know they and so, remember what you have in these areas is ghettos in a sense where communities tend to live together. So it tends to affect communities disproportionately, and the disaffection spreads.
What is your take on this?
So I think three or four. I think one of the most prescient analysis was done by Sushant Paji. I'm not just saying this because he's sitting next to me and he's three times now the weight that I am. He said analysis, election analysis is like, you know, analyzing an elephant in a dark room. Everyone says, ye hai, ye hua. So basically, as the adage goes, you know, success has many fathers, failure is an orphan. बट दो और तीन चीज़ें यहाँ पे मैं कहूँगा, टेकिंग फ्रॉम वॉट अभिजीत इज सेड. आई थिंक इफ देर वॉज नो वेव, एंड मैनी पीपल आर सेइंग दिस वॉज नॉट अ वेव इलेक्शन, देन द लोकल इश्यूज टेक प्रिसिडेंस. एंड वेन द लोकल इश्यूज टेक प्रिसिडेंस, देन यू हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ रिवोल्ट, अपराइजिंग, डिससेटिस्फैक्शन. किसी का घर नहीं बिका, किसी को पैसे नहीं मिले, पानी नहीं आया, सड़क नहीं मिली, ये हुआ, हंड्रेड्स ऑफ थिंग्स, एंड देन इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, ऑलमोस्ट इम्पॉसिबल टू, यू नो, इफ इट्स अ वेवलेस थिंग. द सेकेंड पॉइंट वी नीड टू रियलाइज इज दैट आइदर वी आर ब्लेस्ड और कर्स्ड. माई थिंग इज दैट वी आर ब्लेस्ड टू हैव अ पार्लियामेंटरी टाइप ऑफ थिंग, बिकॉज इफ इट वॉज If it was presidential, then Modi would have won hands down, right? Because what is the alternative?
Asti.
Right? But it was not presidential election. So obviously when local issues take precedence, it is the MP also matters. And if the MP hasn't done any work, the MP has uttered stupid, useless statements like Ayodhya ka contender, for example.
Yeah, the
he was making, I mean, completely juvenile, asinine statements all through, including constitution change hona hai, seriously baat kar raha hai. Amit Shah ka jo video viral hua, wo 7 din baad kisi ko pakda hai. Wo 7 din tak jo artificial intelligence se wo bola ki SC ST ke reservations gayi. So there are multiple reasons. I don't know which one.
Yeah.
I think Paji is right. But having said that, of course you have the gloating rights, but let me again say this, to have formed the government third time round, to beat anti-incumbency of 10 years, Congress after 10 years of anti-incumbency got 52 seats, BJP's got 240, so let's not, yes, you have the gloating rights, no doubt about it.
Yeah.
But it's the situation is not bad at all. Achha, honestly. But
since it's proportion hona
chahiye. Yeah, exactly.
Yaar, dekho, isme aise hai, pehli and the most important thing, you can blame it on anything. Just don't blame it on an air conditioner. Yeah. Right? This whole thing...
Or armchairs.
Armchairs and air conditioners are the two greatest inventions of mankind. And just because somebody has not done well in election, because he was sitting in an AC room, the guy who's done well in elections was also sitting in an AC room. So an AC room has absolutely nothing to do with what has happened.
Okay, so you are now taking off...
Or an AC bus.
Those who are not on Twitter, they don't, or X now, they don't know what you're talking about. Basically, explain. This is on X that there are people who are coming in and all that angst is coming out on X. Where they're saying that ticket distribution was done by people who are... Look, I'm saying because my mom and masis are not on X. So they don't know what you're talking about. कि ये क्या बोल रहा है सुशांत सिंह.
एटलीस्ट ओपनली
एनोनिमस अकाउंट सुशांत
आंटी के हैं. आंटी नोइंग आंटी, शी हैज एन एनोनिमस अकाउंट.
यार सुनो मेरी बात,
100% शी इज द वन हु ट्रोल्स यू मोस्ट.
आई एम टेलिंग यू, शी मस्ट बी ट्रोलिंग यू.
नहीं नहीं, देखो यार, इंडिया में एक तो आदत बन गई है, दे प्रेजेंट एन एयर कंडीशनर लाइक इट्स द ग्रेटेस्ट एक्ट ऑफ डिबॉचरी इन द वर्ल्ड.
नो नो, बट बेसिकली दैट,
डिड यू रीड द न्यूज़ स्टोरी? अरे
बताने दो, दैट व्हाट इज इट अबाउट द एयर कंडीशनर, दैट
द एयर कंडीशनर इज द friend of the people.
People who sit in...
A thief who broke into a house day before yesterday was so enamored by the air conditioner, he forgot to steal and he fell asleep out there and he was caught.
Guess which state?
Which state?
Karnataka.
Uttar Pradesh.
Achha. Okay, no, but the
Kanhaiya
point...
Kumar jab choda,
the point was about giving
tickets,
chala gaya tha, bhai, wo. Giving tickets to people...
Sitting in AC room.
Haan. This is what was the khunnas of people who said that tum log ground mein jo karya karta hai, jo din raat mehnat kar raha hai, jo booth पे चल रहा है, जो पन्ना प्रमुख है, उनकी बातें नहीं सुन रहे हो आप, एसी में बैठ के, एसी रूम्स में बैठ के टिकट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन.
बैड डिसीजंस हैव नथिंग टू डू विद एसी रूम.
बैड. ओके
ओके. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, एंड आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इन एन इलेक्शन बोथ फियर एंड फेक न्यूज वर्क्स. फियर दैट संविधान बदल देंगे, रिजर्वेशन खत्म कर देंगे, दिस वॉज फियर फैक्टर. You were instilling fear. The BJP tried to counter it by this thing that the fear was, ye sari reservation Muslimano ko de denge. One fear worked, the other fear did not work.
The second fear came in too late.
Too late. But along
three
with it,
rounds that happened.
Along with it, the fake news factor. Right? There was a lot of fake news which happened on both sides, but one fake news worked, the other fake news did not work. Number three. Yes, and I think anybody who says, of course the BJP is going to form a government, but anybody who says that, look, the BJP did not lose this election is talking through his hat. Yeah. Exactly. They've lost the election. Yeah. But they will form the government.
Okay.
They've lost the election. Look, number one, they were at 350 as an alliance last time. 353. They've come down to 290. They've lost about over 60 seats. Right? That's a huge loss. So they have lost,
so
but they will form the government.
It's a fractured mandate, it's a loss.
No, I'll come to the mandate in the next point. They've lost, but they will form a government. The India Alliance, in a manner of speaking, has won, but we cannot form the government. It's very clear. That's the mandate. Number four, and this is again very important. You know, this is the elephant in the room. Jiska jo man aata, and this is the greatness of a verdict also, that everybody can pick up something and go away happy, right? Now, people will say, this is a mandate against divisive politics. Yeah, the guy who has voted in UP has not voted on Hindu-Muslim issue necessarily. He has voted on local issues. Now, the same guy in Bihar, so now you're telling me rural distress is maximum in UP. What about Bihar?
No, exactly.
Right? What about, some other state
but
like Madhya Pradesh?
Odisha.
Madhya Pradesh. Odisha.
Odisha is 70%.
So, Anand is right that it's everywhere, so it's a different issue.
No, so break down the election. The BJP has lost in three states. Had it managed to get even half of what it had got last time, they would have romped
over. Then you go with what Tehsin said, ki sabotage ho sakta hai.
Nahin, sabotage, yaar, dekho, no election is won on a single
My
issue.
My theory sounds sexy.
Ek minute.
Abhijit also said that on the ground that there was resentment.
There was resentment. Was there no resentment in MP?
No.
In Gujarat?
No.
So why was there
exactly
in local areas for local? One second, yaar, ek minute, puri baat sun. In local areas for local reasons, there was massive resentment.
Correct.
It was there in UP. There was reason for it to be there in Maharashtra. In Haryana, from where I come, I can tell you the way they've handled the politics of it, they've botched it up completely. Yeah. So Haryana, you remember? Yeah. I think a couple of days I was telling you that this is what I'm hearing. Although the guy in my constituency won, but just barely.
You didn't vote for Raj Babbar?
Just barely, right?
He was in the foreign.
So I think that's it's very important that everybody is picking up on something and walking away with it and pretending that this is why an election has been won.
One second.
Last point. An election is not won on a single issue.
True to what I said.
And is not lost on a single issue. There are a multiplicity of factors. And you know, it's the combination of those factors that decide the outcome of an election in different parts of the country.
Okay, so we'll go one by one so that there's no... When we were talking about, was it there in Bihar, was it not there in all... I need to talk about this exit polls. How did they all get it wrong?
But more than that...
You know, so what happened when my reporters were telling me something, I was like, but exit polls are saying this. We just get taken in and then everybody that echo chamber or whatever.
Yeah. Let me add something to these exit polls. And this is something very serious we should all talk about. All these hedge funds, etc., they were getting exit polls done, putting it out, and this should be a criminal investigation. I'm very upset with them. All these funds, and they're saying, oh, ab 400 par ho gaya, 500, put money in. After 4 June, your money will double. All of these funds. Mm. Now, these exit
polls. Why is it criminal?
I'll tell you why it's criminal. Because the
manipulation.
That's straight up market manipulation. You are telling a common man who believes. People take exit polls very seriously. Now you have a hedge fund goes about, gets an exit poll commissioned. You don't know by whom. There's no scientific data. Data's not put out. And you tell an investor who's probably putting his lifetime savings, removing from an FD, taking a loan, saying, oh, the market will go up after 4 June. Abhi dalo ise. How can this be allowed? SEBI should have stepped in. The television regulators should have stepped in. The courts should have stepped in. Election commission should have stepped in. What business do they have to do surveys? And if those surveys are being done, the complete data should be put out. How
for your allegation to be true, I'm not saying it's false, but I'm saying for it to be true, the investigation has to be that, okay, did somebody get the shares jacked up, the market rigged, and then sell big time, made massive profits, and bought the same shares again?
Correct.
If that investigation turns out to be, suggest what you are saying, then I think criminal action should be taken.
So basically, like George Soros short selling, using Hindenburg to short sell this thing.
Adani.
But the other thing, the other way of looking at it is that after that first fall and then it's back.
It's back.
We need to separate. We see there's two different things out here.
Yeah.
Who funds these exit polls?
No, one is the exit. One is the hedge fund aspect of it that he has raised the market manipulation, which is a very valid point. But second, I want to defend those exit polls. They all got the percentages lagbhag right.
Almost right, yeah.
Theek hai? Yeah, the problem was with even with those percentages right,
the seat-to-seat prediction is virtually impossible. Ultimately,
right?
What are you going with? You're going with seats.
But should we not do seats anymore? Should exit polls not come that we do a percentage? Because seat distribution in a country.
Then it doesn't matter.
How do you do seat distribution?
No, but to be fair to Yashwant Deshmukh, he always said.
No, I don't want to go by single person.
But I'm just saying.
Because then Yogendra Yadav bhi lana padega.
Yeah, but uska record. देखो तो वो कितनी बारी गलत हुआ है इस बार तुक्का लग गया
टुडेस चाणक्य देखो यार
टुडेस चाणक्य इज
ऑलवेज बीन रॉन्ग नो नो एंड सत्ता बाजार देखो
राइट नाउ लेट अस जस्ट एडमिट दैट आई एम जस्ट अबाउट एज राइट एज एवरीबॉडी एल्स ओके आई हैव गॉट वेस्ट बंगाल 2021 आई गॉट राइट एंड आई गॉट ट्रंप 2016 राइट
यार यू हैव
ब्रोकन क्लॉक इज
ओके
ट्वाइस अ डे सो आई टेल यू
आई ब्रोकन क्लॉक
प्लीज आई एम द वर्ल्ड्स ग्रेटेस्ट सेफोलॉजिस्ट
ओके नो वन सेकंड द ओके स्मिता
Not even the
homophobia.
Homophobia. No, homophobia. Sarina will walk out.
I was told
Hello.
I was threatened in the ANI studio by homophobic Smita Prakash.
Nobody even calls you an authentic cook. Forget about being an authentic cook.
Have you burned that protest placard?
No.
He's not even shaving his head now. He said ki main baal mundwa lunga.
Are you Somnath Bharti?
You also said.
No, I said agar 295, agar India ka, agar India का 295 पार होगा मैं नाच करूंगा
एनडीए
वाज सेव्ड बिकॉज ऑफ मी बिकॉज पीपल सॉ दैट थ्रेट and the EVM saw that threat the EVMs got scared and they said ठीक है हम NDA को 295 नहीं देंगे
देखो all your general election predictions are wrong all your general
two Punjabis together it doesn't work right
excuse me I'm the only true Tamilian here actually half को तो वो तो बंगाली है उसकी क्या बात है
हाँ true Tamilian
but I want
तू आधा तू पंजाबी you can't even this question Tamil पैसिया Tamil पैसे
Tamil तेरी माँ एक अपना
This is an insult to the
Hello, hello, hello. Static, static, hello, static.
What are you doing? You're still
there. Hello, static.
Total paitya.
Total paitya.
I can't hear it.
This is like that meme. राइट मोदी जी फोन कर रहे हैं नीतीश बाबू को नीतीश बाबू हेलो
किससे बात करनी है
आई हैव टू रन दीज मीम्स एंड गेट योर रिएक्शंस ऑन दीज ये देखा है ये बीजेपी बिहाइंड द सीन्स बीजेपी फोन कर रहा है नीतीश
को दूसरे कान से
हां दूसरे कान से एंड देन दैट वन
कांग्रेट्स ऑन द विन नीतीश जी शुक्रिया
बदल लेंगे
दिस वाज हिलेरियस राइट हाँ दिस पलट पलट
नीतीश सबके
हाँ दिस वाज सो करेक्ट
बट यू रीड द ट्वीट दैट द जेडीयू पुट आउट आफ्टर द विन
सेइंग
व्हाट
द ट्वीट वाज दैट न्याय का हाथ विकास के साथ ही पुट आउट दैट ट्वीट
ये मी इफ बीजेपी विंस मी इफ कांग्रेस विंस
हमारा इतना ये था वी वर ऑन द फ्लाइट बैक फ्रॉम बैंकॉक
ये दिस इज द बेस्ट काशी और मथुरा यूपी दिस काशी मथुरा द अदर स्टेट्स आर पार्ट हां भाई आनंद मथुरा बीटिंग आनंद काशी मथुरा फॉरगेट अबाउट योर 4000 टेंपल्स 40,000 टेंपल्स
अरे देयर इज नो प्रूफ ऑफ 40 यार ये पता नहीं कहां से
आई डिड नॉट ब्रिंग दैट दिस थिंग यार
जो भी बट द पॉइंट इज काशी मथुरा गोज ऑन द बैक बर्नर आफ्टर दिस मतलब अगर अयोध्या में ऐसे हुआ
यार 400 साल हो गया तो 4 साल और
आनंद को बोलने दो
सी आई थिंक आई एम नॉट दैट वरीड अबाउट काशी एंड मथुरा बिकॉज इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ द कोर्ट टू डिसाइड नाउ राइट आई एम वरीड अबाउट द अदर 7 और 8 थिंग्स acts, legislations that the Hindus were being actively and rampantly being discriminated against. Hmm. They are now completely out of the window. I am worried about Place of Worship Act. Hmm. That will remain. RTE 93rd Amendment ke saath jo conjunction hai, that is shutting down, making only Hindu-run schools shut down, you know. Waqf Act will remain. So many other things that temples will remain under state control, right? Mm-hmm. Especially Chandrababu Naidu now.
Abhi kyun nahi change kar diya pichle 5 saal
But I'm not coming to that. We've been crying for that. I mean, I wrote a book कि बीजेपी ने नहीं किया, गलतियां थी. दो बार मेजॉरिटी मिलने के बाद जब वो हिंदू से डिस्क्रिमिनेशन नहीं हटा पाए तो अब तो सवाल ही नहीं है. सो बट अदर देन दैट आई वॉन्ट टू ब्रिंग द लार्जर इशू आउट हियर. यू सी ओके येस ही हैज द ग्लोटिंग राइट्स, नो डाउट अबाउट इट ऑफकोर्स, एंड आई मे डिसएग्री दैट बीजेपी हैज लॉस्ट एज पाजी सेज. द फैक्ट ऑफ द मैटर इज कि 145 कांग्रेस के मिले थे, उसके बाद भी नाच रहे थे, खुशी से सरकार बनाई. 206 मिले, खुशी से सरकार बनाई. अब 10 साल की एंटी इनकम्बेंसी के बाद अब वही है, रीजन ढूंढने निकलेंगे तो बहुत सारे रीजन्स हैं. यस, सो मेनी थिंग्स दैट कुड हैव गॉन रॉन्ग एक्चुअली डिड गो रॉन्ग. इफ यू रिमूव द 3 स्टेट्स, BJP has not done bad at all. I mean, if you look at the vote share of other than the three,
Odisha,
मतलब कोई ऐसा इलेक्शन रिजल्ट बताइए जहां पे 30 साल बाद सरकार पलट गई और people are not just discussing it at all. It's unbelievable.
It's more than three. It's 5 state है. Maharashtra, I expected it to go wrong, but not the kind of reversal we saw. ठीक है. Rajasthan, they lost 10 seats, boss.
Yeah.
That is no joke.
Vasundhara factor and the chief minister completely.
No, no, no.
Vasundhara did not
campaign for excellence. Let me finish quickly. UP, West Bengal. West Bengal, we expected to grow very significantly after all the thing, after the cadre was wiped out by Mamata Banerjee.
Haryana, and, Punjab.
This thing. Haryana, we expected it. Yeah, it
Punjab.
Punjab, I never saw a regrowth of the Congress. Punjab, I'm very happy with because I knew the BJP had zero prospects.
And AAP
but I didn't want AAP to have any prospects. I'm glad
Congress
the
won.
Congress won because as anarchists go, they're nowhere near the caliber of
Yeah, but AAP. Look at the kind of statement that the Congress former chief minister, who is now a member of parliament, Channi, has made. You know, look at the kind of other statements that people from the Congress party have made. And you know, this is what is the tragedy of the Congress party, that and this is one thing I think my one big takeaway is on both the big parties, I think they need to change their advisors.
Big time.
People who are giving them political advice, both in the Congress party, right, which has I consider it to be an NGO of
sorts. BJP कोई advice नहीं दे रहा.
नहीं नहीं यार दे रहे हैं वो जिस
तरह से लोग ज्ञान सब जानते हैं यार.
मोदी को कौन advice दे रहा है?
I tell you this happens after 10 years. I think or in the second term of any party they think हमको पता है भाई, हम we know everything.
But let me tell you something about Maharashtra, it's very interesting. So I was in Mumbai for dinner, and there were these gynecs and other doctors, mostly Brahmins, who were traditionally Congress voters, and then had moved to BJP. And the reason these guys had moved to BJP is because the Congress leadership over the last 20 years had become Marathas. This is from Mr. Pawar took over, so Ashok Chavan, Vilas Rao Deshmukh. Congress always a Maratha chief minister and vice versa. NCP is a Maratha party. The hatred for Ajit Pawar, and I'm using a very strong word, amongst the educated in Maharashtra, amongst the white-collared against the businessmen, is very, Ajit Pawar is not a very light man. He's very, he, everybody knows he's hand in glove with the builders. Everybody knows he's very powerful. He controls bureaucracy. In fact, even in the MBA government, any file over 1 crore, Ajit Pawar would sign because he was finance minister. Why should my minister, if I'm Congress, be waiting outside Ajit Pawar? He should sign his NCP files. Why should Congress minister?
Yeah, isko defamation ka dar kyun nahi hai?
Mujhe koi dar nahi, kar rahe Ajit Pawar mujhe defamation.
Ye khud hi logon ke upar.
So, now the thing is, so these guys.
Matlab hum jaise log hi jail jaye. बच जाता है यार ये,
सॉरी. So these voters, when we're doing dinner, were so upset with Mr. Modi personally and Amit Shah ji, so upset. They said the whole reason for us shifting to BJP was to escape Ajit Pawar and stuff. If you are getting them back into BJP, and please remember, Fadnavis, for all my opposition to BJP, was a very liked chief minister. He wasn't really communal. He understood development. He understood.
Well, he's taken personal responsibility.
Imagine.
My respect for Fadnavis went through the roof.
And abhi the other person my respect on is Shivraj Chauhan.
What a man.
Yeah. What a man. What has he delivered, man? Yeah. 8 lakh
votes, 20-0. No, forget it. Not once complained.
Not Tessi, not just his constituency. Yeah. He delivered Madhya Pradesh in the last
20-0.
You changed him. Okay, fine. You changed him. You brought in Rajasthan, you brought in a chief minister who's a first-time MLA, right? Who doesn't know a damn thing. Nobody knew the guy. You just picked up somebody. Yaar, kisi credible face ko bana dete.
Did you see Vasundhara's face when she opened that chit?
You know, must get that. And they should have learned this from that chap they put in Karnataka, Bombay. That these kind of unknown people, where everything, say, state elections are determined on state, National elections are determined on national, ठीक है, but if your state doesn't perform, your national will not perform.
So they brought back Yediyurappa and now they asked the Devegowda family that aa jao, because they needed that South Karnataka, which they made a mistake in not doing that in the state elections and they lost. This time they brought back all these people and went back to the drawing board.
Hence, I want a discussion, you know.
Yeah.
If you're looking at center, and I'm not taking I'm basically tilted towards something that I'm going to propose here against it. Should we have a presidential election for the center, or should we keep it like this parliamentary?
Yeah, you have a good system working.
Yeah.
It's a system which works.
Don't fix it.
Don't try and
fix something that's not broken.
You know, and this is my problem also with things like one nation, one election.
Yeah.
It is a problem that if every 3 months, but every 3 months it's a problem for the BJP because their star candidate is also happens to be the Prime Minister.
Mm.
If you had strong leadership at the state level, then if every 3 months some state or the other in the union is going for election, what's the problem? In fact, it acts as a kind of a circuit breaker.
Exactly.
It acts like a safety wall.
It acts as a warning.
Which is why I'm for the parliamentary system, because the performance of the MPs ultimately decides who's going to rule the center.
Yeah. Unlike
sir, reality
US.
Check. US mein yaar, aapka state nahi hai, senate nahi hai, congress nahi hai, lekin aap jeete pade.
Just to point out, 21 out of the 26 candidates that they got from the congress,
they lost.
Yeah.
I was about to say that.
Kyon lie?
Including Kripa Shankar Singh.
Especially Kripa Shankar Singh. I want all the audience to know. Kripa Shankar Singh is the fellow who wrote 2611 RSS ki saazish hai. Usko BJP ke andar laya bhi nahi gaya. Usko ticket bhi diya gaya.
Immediately.
Aur wo bhi Jaunpur se.
Yeah. Wo shot lagana
namaz mein. Wo to ganimat hai Ayodhya se nahi diya.
But this is like I said.
Ayodhya explain.
We'll just come to Ayodhya. But one more thing. You know, you're not the Congress party. You have a different way this party has come up. Now, in this kind of a party, you suddenly bring in these people who are floating all over the place and you hand them tickets. Right? आप देखो आप पकड़ पकड़ के लोगों को लेके आते हो and you suddenly air parachute a person and expect them to win a parliamentary election. Tell me something. In Mumbai, for example, Ujjwal Nikam might be a good lawyer, bad lawyer, I don't care.
He lost.
He had to lose. What
yeah,
is his connection with the people?
You replaced Poonam Mahajan,
who's
an old delivering
MP.
Poonam Mahajan ka us constituency ke saath kitna connect hai? Saalo ka connect ho, uske papa ke naam se connect hai. She's a well-performing MP. You remove her
and you bring in this guy.
What is the basis for bringing him in? He hanged Ajmal Kasab. Ye koi basis hota hai to connect with people? किसी को फांसी चढ़ा है तो भाई लोगों के लिए क्या किया तूने?
But he, you know, okay, fine.
They have lost 4 seats.
Kasab and everything, but remember, I'll never forget this. He said Kasab ko biryani chahiye.
Which was not true.
It was not true.
It was not true. And he polarized it. It was a terrible thing. And it's terrible for a prosecutor too.
The problem is that they say the law is an ass. Sometimes it's not the law, it's the lawyers.
Lawyers work. Yeah.
You know, but out of the four of you, excuse me, I am the only one that has been to jail. So let me comment on this. Jail mein biryani milta hai.
No, I've been to lockup.
Chicken.
Really?
Lockup is not jail.
Wo onion prices ke chakkar mein.
Yeah, main lockup.
Yaar,
aisa badmash hai.
Mera story bahut interesting hai.
Nahi, police ne kaha ki aap sir aap kaise aa gaye yahan pe?
I'll tell you.
Kehta mujhe arrest karo.
Courting arrest.
They take me to lockup. They put me in the lockup.
You're too pretty to be in the lockup.
That's what I mean. You have all these cops taking selfies, and Indian Express has a front page picture of me taking selfies with all the women cops.
Yes, who was that? Ajay Rai, who was in AAP and then changed to Congress.
Ajay Rai was not. No,
Ajay. Who was that one? IAS officer.
Ajoy Kumar.
He's the one who said about Draupadi Murmu.
So he was the one. You remember when a lot of Congressees were courting arrest?
Congress.
Now he's in Congress. So when a lot of Congressees were being arrested at Vijay Chowk or somewhere like that, he ran after a bus. Mujhe bhi pakdo.
Mujhe bhi arrest karo.
No, but he's a very nice guy.
See, what happens in jail is you get non-veg on 4 days. Okay.
In Odisha.
In Odisha.
Not Uttar Pradesh.
Are sar jagah milta hai.
Kya baat kar
rahe ho? Milta hai.
Gujarat.
You get chicken, Twice.
But you don't know whether it's fish. Chicken or crow.
No, no, you can tell it's chicken.
Hi, hi.
See, you're a vegetarian. You can't tell non-veg flavors.
Food leke aao.
I am non-vegetarian.
Khana lao. Wo to nutri nugget kha ke sochta hai. Khana
khane ke liye aaye the. Tumhare liye thodi na aaye the.
This is very unfair. You got four hardcore soya chaap
kha ke mutton job kha rahe.
Third rice wala. Chameleon here. Third rice chameleon.
Soya khayega to estrogenation hoga. Soya khana
banta. Ask him for the Tamilian word for curd rice, please.
What's curd rice in Tamil?
Now, if I say, what do I get in return?
No curd rice.
Tire Sadam, of course.
Okay.
Okay, not bad.
Not bad.
It's not
bad.
What do you mean? I'm a true blue Tamilian.
I'll tell you how he knows this. He's gone to that restaurant.
Anand Ranganathan. On the ANI platform, I challenge you to an elocution contest in Tamil.
Accepted. Static.
Okay. Ippove aarambikkalam.
No, I didn't say I accepted it. Let's do it in 2029. We'll assemble in 2029.
He's saying
same. And then let's see who will have the gloating rights.
He says say the same thing in Tamil.
Aaja Punjabi cha aaja tu.
Say 2029 in Tamil. Say 2029 in Tamil.
Hello, static.
In Tamil, there's no 2029.
There is very much. Bol, Tamil, me. Bol. Bol.
Acha, what were we discussing? We're digressing.
Hey, Anand Ranganathan.
He was talking about tension.
Challenge karta hu. Bol, 2029.
करता हूँ कह रहा
है
What about now, your women?
Hello,
karta
stop,
hu.
Stop, stop.
Look at the way I've caught him.
He diverted. He diverted.
Achha, what about your jail?
2029 Tamil mein kya hota hai?
No, no, but let's...
Arre, Tamil mein hota hi nahi hai 2029.
Hota hai.
Tab tak Tamil wale wo nahi rahega.
My Punjabi Aryan invader insulting Tamil culture saying we don't know. Sab iska muh dekho DMK, DMK ko tag karo. Iske khilaf julus arrest
him. We'll ask Annamalai. No, Annamalai.
No, no, but Smita...
What happened to Annamalai?
Nahi, nahi.
No, did you see the goat?
Yeah.
This thing?
They put a stuck a photo of Annamalai on a goat's head and beheaded it. Yeah. So now there is no death of democracy. Now there is nothing.
No, but you know what? It's about time that this Sartan se juda and this thing, this slogan Sartan se juda should be declared illegal. I just feel that.
Not just that. It should be prosecuted in a terror charges.
I think so too.
Yeah.
When you talk about beheading people, now this is mass beheading. Sartan se juda. It's nothing short of spreading terror. Mm. So there should be terror laws applied.
I agree.
But you what cannot, is it?
Not
that,
just that.
What is Annamalai doing, which is getting people so riled up? What is he doing?
Yeah, they got zero more vote share than Congress has.
No, yeah.
They got zero seats. So why is DMK so upset with Annamalai?
Because they know. See, two things have happened. First of all, for the first time, the ADMK. See, normally the ADMK and DMK would be within about 2% of each other. This time, the ADMK has come down by 5 points, which has never happened.
20%, no? Something
like that. 20% and DMK is 25.
5%.
And there's been a transference of that vote share to the BJP. Mm. So they now see a new party ascendant, which becomes the biggest threat. Because you don't want... See, Congress won't win a single seat without the DMK support.
That's not true. Huh? Congress adds to the Dravidian parties. Tamil Nadu is different.
Let me 2% vote down.
Doesn't matter. In Tamil Nadu, Congress...
Tamil Nadu, inka kuch nahi...
Sorry, 10% vote.
Yeah, that's
right. They won't be able BJP to... Chidambaram, Manishankar Iyer, they won't be able to...
Manishankar can't win all its...
They can't win a council election.
That's fine.
Council election bhi nahi jeetenge.
True, but...
Achha, Abhijit, Karthi Van, right? DMK aur BJP ka coalition hota, do you think Tamil Nadu...
Exactly.
See, better. Not really. I'll tell you why. Because 25 plus the 10 point something percent 11, that Congress got.
Achha, okay.
That Congress got was higher than the 10 plus 20% that ADMK
just
got.
Just about, yeah.
So, you know, I think Annamalai made the absolute right call that we need to stand on our own. We need to plant our flag because unless we do that and learn to walk on our own, we're always going to be conjoined
like
by
Bengal.
ADMK,
but I think you also hit the nail on the head after the first round of voting when you were telling me that
They
didn't manage the election area.
See,
very
that
well.
That happened.
They managed the campaigning well.
That day itself, my mom called up Annamalai and told him, Anna, there is stuff happening out there. You need to pay attention to it. Her people on the ground were telling her that the poll management, the booth management,
which
is
brings
horribly,
me to the
wrong.
Crux.
The
crux.
Booth management.
No, crux. Was RSS and its involvement lukewarm this time?
Very much so. It was visibly so.
And then why?
Visibly so.
Why?
Because.
The reason why I'm saying this
in many ways, Paji, this was a more important election than 2014.
No, one second.
As far as RSS is
concerned. Okay, so you have no...
So there are many things that one can see. Were they miffed? Were they just tired? You know, in the sense that 10 years of power.
They're tireless.
Did they get the signals from the BJP that we can do this on our own? We don't need
number
you.
Three.
Number
right?
three.
Was hubris. Yeah.
A large chunk is saying that that could be the reason. Four, not motivated enough. आपने 400 पार बोल दिए तो आप अपने आप ही कर लो फिर अगर आपने 400 बार
नहीं उसमें देखो I think all of these factors are there but
part and part
but you are certain RSS was lukewarm.
No, I'll tell you why I'm saying it although there are some people who deny it. The reason I'm saying number one go back to 2004 when the BJP lost in 2004 even then it was said that the RSS had pulled its hands off right. And the reason is, you have to, number one, understand the RSS psyche. From what I have been able to make out, the RSS says, look, we are here to stay. No matter what somebody does to us, we are here to stay. And we have a certain vision which we want should come into play. And if that means that this time these guys are not going to do it, there will be another time. They follow that logic of, we have the time and they have the watches, right? Number one. Number two, the reason I'm saying this is, when the Ram Temple Pran Pratishtha was to happen, in a place where I stay, you know, that's a kind of a place where, you know, normally you don't have the rough and tumble of politics. But even there, there were a whole lot of these guys from the RSS and others who were coming and giving you those invitation cards and stuff like that. This time around, unlike 2014 and 2019, when, you know, people were coming, distributing tickets, trying to convince you, putting up a, you know, pamphlet or something in your house, sannata, complete sannata.
Yeah. Right? I did not.
There was no campaigning, nothing.
Nobody
so
came.
So there was no, nobody came. So I got this feeling and I started asking around. So some people said yes,
but
some people
responsible
said they've done
for
it
that?
In parts and not in parts.
That you must answer.
The reasons are partly
is BJP responsible for that?
Yeah, of course.
Is it BJP or is it two or three people in BJP?
No, no, but nobody came from any party, yaar. किसी भी पार्टी से मेरे मद्रास के घर में जहां वेयर आई एक्चुअली
हमारे यहां आम आदमी पार्टी वाले आए
यू कॉल इट चेन्नई आई कॉल इट मद्रास थैंक यू वेरी मच
उनका तो सूखा था हो गया वो बड़ा
सेलिब्रेट वी आर गोइंग दिस विल लीड टू अस गेटिंग सूड एंड
कॉल मद्रास Please, I still believe in the
our picture will be on the
in the greatness and the goodness of the British.
Taking your water.
In the greatness and the goodness of the British. See, even he dresses, he's the last Englishman surviving. He asli mein jawahar
don't discount Rishi Sunak.
So well dressed.
Going to get.
He's the true.
I have to make up. I have to make up for three louts out here. That's the reason.
Yes, yes.
देखो native decolonized natives को इसने lout बोला. ये है Churchill का पूत.
Talking of Churchill, who quoted Churchill? He won, Manish Tiwari.
Manish Tiwari.
But by 2000,
he will Churchill. Fight on the beaches.
See, it doesn't matter how, nobody remembers how the loser, how much the loser lost by. They only remember who the
how
winner was.
How many did you win?
35.
No, 2,500 votes.
That's it.
That's
fine.
Yeah, but there are so many places, ek vote.
Again, Manish
the closest
Tiwari
is Shiv Sena. 47.
Manish Tiwari is a fantastic
human
being.
He's a very good guy. Yeah. He's a good, and it's good that he has. I don't have any problem to see a Manish Tiwari. In fact, I think it's an asset in Parliament.
Yeah.
Whether you agree with him or you don't agree with him is a different matter, right? But he's an asset in Parliament. But I was a little disappointed to see that tweet of his. You know, what are you trying to do? What was the whole opposition trying to do? Incite a civil war or what?
Emotions mein beh gaya tha.
Nahi karna chahiye na yaar. Itne aap seasoned politician ho. You've been there. You've seen it. You've
Chalo
fought yaar, elections.
Sab,
won,
sab
lost.
Koi na koi. Maine bhi Odisha mein tweet kiya. Aur dekho Odisha mein kya hua.
Nahi, nahi. But see, this is what I'm trying to say is that this is a confirmation bias which many of us have.
Yeah.
You like a person and then when that person loses, even if you don't, you feel bad. You like a person and you dislike a person and that person wins. फिर यू गेट अपसेट सो यू नो ये पर्सनल लाइक्स एंड डिसलाइक्स के एको चेंबर में अच्छे हैं हम लोग
नीड टू डिस्कस स्मृति ईरानी एंड अयोध्या एंड देन वी मूव ऑन टू द
सो सो ऑन द फर्स्ट वन
बिकॉज़ दीस आर शॉकर्स
ऑन द
स्मृति ईरानी
एंड दे आर द वंस द टू मोस्ट इशू टू इश्यूज दैट पीपल आर डिस्कसिंग
ऑन द एक्स एमपी ऑफ अमेठी अगेन ऑन टीवी आई केप्ट सेइंग आई थिंक वन ऑफ द शोज यू वर देयर दैट शी विल लूज बाय ओवर 1 लाख एंड एवरीवन केप्ट लाफिंग आई केप्ट सेइंग शी विल लूज बाय ओवर 1 लाख आई वाज इन अमेठी ट्वाइस आई वेंट And everyone was saying that the ex-MP's only obsession was with Rahul Gandhi.
It's a difficult question.
Chotu is from Amethi only. He focuses on Amethi.
Are.
First was the Dalit vote transference that happened out there. The second was very specifically the Thakur and upper caste sit out there.
Really?
The Thakur's
in Ayodhya, it was a very clear
but
case
why
of Ayodhya.
Angry with
Yeah, Ayodhya.
They were angry with Smriti or they were angry with Modi. You know, you have to decipher that.
It's more of anger with Modi.
Yeah.
And Yogi. Because jo bhi wo mang rahe the, wo ho hi nahi raha tha. What is the point of... See, we look at seats, you know, we've got this very urbane sort of view of a seat as being an individual to win. They see it as community property
so
for the community.
They didn't know the candidate at all, right?
No,
they
I can, had, no, I
you have to answer this.
I'm coming.
Who
no,
K. Sharma, they knew.
Everyone.
He lives there.
Of course, he lives there.
He knows Gully. He knows everybody.
He knows everyone.
I met him. I interviewed him. And he's such a soft-spoken, sweetser guy.
Even his daughters are so
He's so different from Smriti Irani in the sense Smriti is very... she's an aggressive politician from the word go. He's a very pavam, very mild-mannered and sober.
He was the bridge between the Gandhis and Amethi and Rai Bareli. Yeah. He continued to be the bridge.
Yeah.
And everybody knew them. Very calm, dignified person. Will all speak with respect. In fact, you should see his post-interviews after he won and
yeah, he's not gloated.
No, even Smriti Irani did not castigate him at any point of time.
She did in the beginning. She said ke on the first day when chaprasi ko bheja hai.
Nee, on the first day when they nominated because she was
chaprasi ko. She did say that, which is not. Okay. And I'll tell you, there's a pattern in our country. Every time someone's been arrogant, you see, even whenever you say about somebody, there's a chaparasi, who's this, kinse photo khichwa di, jo hamare saath selfie lete the aaj ji.
Manishankar Iyer.
Everyone. This country does not
Manishankar Iyer ko mention kiya na. There are motor mouths in both parties.
Yeah.
Right? But unlike what everybody was expecting, that people like Petroda and Manishankar Iyer would damage the Congress, it was the motor mouths of the BJP
the
who
BJP.
Damaged it.
Seems like come on, that wealth distribution thing that came
in. No, but I'll tell you something. That wealth distribution thing was played out very, very wrongly by the BJP.
True.
You think so?
Mismanaged it completely. No. You liked it because you belong to a certain class which actually feels. Yeah, Madhuki, you are an upper middle class kind of a guy. You are 1%.
No, but if you scare me,
I'm a loyal servant.
You are a 1%. Look at the suit he's wearing.
I am a very loyal servant.
They didn't play it out well.
You're a taxpayer.
Explain this. Explain this.
You're luxury.
See, the moment you are talking.
Let him explain this.
Bespoke suit.
See, I'll tell you why they didn't play out well. The same message which people like Modi and others were giving on this wealth distribution thing. If you are at the bottom of the pile, what are you going to say? वो किसी ने बोला भी है कि भाई आप बोल रहे हो कि उसकी दो भैंसें हैं एक उससे लेके आपको दे देगा तो वो कहते हैं मेरे पास तो एक भी भैंस नहीं है मेरे पास तो भैंस आनी है
exactly
fair point
right so the way they played it out was I
can
think
I rebut
it,
that?
It didn't really work out very well on the ground.
See, you say is half true. I'll tell you why.
I don't believe that. They played it pretty good and they just didn't continue with it for long.
Just a small rebuttal because you're not off the mark.
Mm.
You see, the thing with wealth redistribution is that the poorest of the poor would love it. As you said, किसी के पास भैंस नहीं है वो कहेगा भाई मुझे क्या पड़ी है सो द इमेज दैट राहुल गांधी वॉन्टेड एंड सैम वॉन्टेड टू प्रोजेक्ट वॉज कि हम करप्ट क्रोनी कैपिटलिस्ट जो बिलियनियर्स हैं अदानी अंबानी की वेल्थ को रिडिस्ट्रीब्यूट करेंगे तो जो पुअरेस्ट हैं सो इकोनॉमिक स्टार्टअप में वो कहेंगे हाँ भाई करो टू काउंटर दैट इज द रीजन वाई मोदी ब्रॉट इन मंगल सूत्र बिकॉज इट सेट दिस वेल्थ रिडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज नॉट जस्ट गोइंग टू अफेक्ट अदानी अंबानी सो डोंट बी प्लीज विद दैट इट्स गोना अफेक्ट यू I thought that was brilliant.
Exactly.
I don't think they were able to behold the Prime Minister to use that language. Why not? There are two things to this. Number one, they did not press home the point well enough. They made it for a couple of things and then they moved on. So it didn't really filter down that message. It did not become a sustained part of the campaign.
It wasn't sustained.
Right?
It wasn't sustained.
Number one. Number two, the other mess up which happened was that when they started talking about this whole Mangalsutra thing, what he was trying to do is he was trying to touch a raw nerve in everybody's mind. And the
fear
reason for that,
saying.
By that time, that whole thing, ke ye jo reservation hai, ye isko scrap kar denge. See, for example,
so now we're talking about all the disinformation campaigns which went on.
Here is the thing.
They might have a grain of truth in it, but they made a full khichdi out of it.
So when a BJP MP says कि हमको इतने नंबर चाहिए ताकि हम संविधान बदल सके, व्हाट वर दे टॉकिंग अबाउट? दे वर नॉट सेइंग कि वी आर गोइंग टू स्क्रैप द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. दे वर सेइंग कि अगर हम यूसीसी लेके आना चाहते हैं, इफ यू वांट टू ब्रिंग इन यूसीसी यू हैव टू चेंज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, यू वांट टू ब्रिंग इन अ नंबर ऑफ रिफॉर्म्स यू हैव टू चेंज, यू हैव टू अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, नॉट चेंज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. दे डिड नॉट, हैड दे सेड हम संविधान में संशोधन करना चाहते हैं, इट वॉज वन थिंग. आप संशोधन बोलो और आप बोलो हम संविधान को बदलना चाहते हैं, एक नया संविधान लाना चाहते हैं,
यू नो.
सो एक मिनट. सो व्हाट हैपेंड वाज दैट दिस स्टार्टेड फिल्टरिंग डाउन. प्लीज रिमेंबर इन द फर्स्ट टू राउंड्स डिड मोदी एवर मेंशन मुस्लिम
इन द सेकंड राउंड?
Around the second round, when they realized that the rumors about this whole reservation thing had really caught fire and they were not able to counter it, that is when he started talking about it. I don't blame him.
After the first round,
it was a survival strategy.
So after the first round, 102 odd seats, where, like your mother said, the BJP messed up. They were expecting
first
three in Tamil Nadu.
First round was south,
They were expecting three in Tamil Nadu. Then the news came in zero. That's when the Prime Minister started this language. Until then, I was cheering for the Prime Minister. Of course, I wanted Congress to win, but cheering that he threw out all the hate mongers, good campaign, you're running on development, and suddenly he's using words like Muslim, Muslim League, Mangal Sutra, Bhes, Guy. It doesn't behove the Prime Minister. But let me come to a larger point.
Let him complete.
I do a lot of meditation with bureaucrats. A lot of bureaucrats. We have a group and we do a lot of meditation. And a lot of IAS and IPS officers, I'm talking serving IAS and IPS officers, were spooked with this 400 comment and the changing of constitution. And I can tell you the amount of them, they were worried. They thought that this would, now they would become completely subservient to constitutional change. I'm not even talking about retired army IAS officers. They were so, so upset. And this is for the first time in bureaucracy. If you see the data of the votes, how it's split, bureaucracy has gone 50-50. They voted NDA and they voted India Alliance. First time youngsters, the first time voters and the second time, and the 18 to 25 and the 25 to 30 have overwhelmingly voted India.
No, one
Something
second.
Has changed.
About bureaucracy,
yeah.
the reason why bureaucrats get spooked is not because of what a politician says. Somewhere that talk about bureaucratic reforms, lateral entries, these are things which spook the bureaucrat the most about lateral entries, because that means ek exam dekh ke tum nahi aayo. The lateral entries are going to come from IITs and
IIMs.
Which
is terrible for the country.
Great point, jo ki reh gaya because we very quickly shifted to other people. Let me explain on that. If only the upper echelons of BJP had realized ki there is nothing wrong in saying, talking about constitution, as long as you say we want to amend it. They could have further elaborated. We want to remove the word socialism. Agar unki himmat nahi wo mat kaho. UCC lan, jaise aapne example diya. Amend karo constitution, yeah. Lekin wo batana nahi, abstract mein rakhna. I want the constitution to be amended. I want it. Yeah. I want UCC to come. I
Congress
want socialism to be removed.
Yeah, yeah.
108 baar
kiya. It's already amended 120 odd times. Ah. So then, the amendment.
I didn't realize this till, again, you know, my RA pointed this out to me on the WhatsApp.
Ab to RA ko laane.
Yaar, ye RA ko lao. Yaar, ye 4 baar kya chuka hai, yaar, bhai.
You get your RA, I'll get my
RA. So, what he was pointing out was that, you know, we were looking at this as constitutional change. That wasn't the way it was being peddled in those WhatsApp groups. It was constitutional change to take away reservations.
Yeah.
Right. That was the connection the BJP did not make.
Yeah.
That was being made in all the Congress WhatsApp groups.
Yeah.
But see, it's a fantastic campaign. Today, that spirit of Congress guy, he's been congratulated officially by all kinds of Congress people. And he's like, yes, thank you. I made a fake video and very good. I'm glad I accept full responsibility for it. And
खुशी खुशी जेल जाए, आजादी के लिए जेल जाए.
But this whole reservation thing in the by the second round, see, this is what is happening, is that the Congress set the narrative and the BJP was responding to everything, whether it was the wrong one of Manishankar Iyer and Sam Pitroda, or whether it was this one about Samvidhan Badal Denge. The BJP was on the back foot right from the beginning.
So you know why?
Which I don't understand.
This was the first election. This was the first election where Rahul Gandhi wasn't made a Pappu out of. They turned him into Darth Vader.
Hmm.
And you know, if anybody watches Star Wars here, I support Darth Vader. He's the bad guy you root for.
Yeah. Do you? I never liked Darth
this
Vader.
Time there was no, no, there
he
was
has
no
an appeal.
What an appeal. No, he has a massive fan club.
Massive fan club.
Okay, it's so the biggest fan club
in the Star Wars series.
It's like it's
for
like
men.
If you read
for women it's Princess Leia.
Yeah, for women.
But but look, this was the first election.
It was Harrison Ford.
No, no. Amongst the women and
this
men
this was the first election
about.
Where they didn't papuize Rahul Gandhi and I think that cost them.
They did, but
they should
they,
have.
No,
they didn't at
Kuch
all.
It didn't work.
It didn't stick. They tried to. It didn't stick.
And he's not.
They didn't try.
This election has
they
proved
tried to,
he
they
has changed.
Tried
he's
to port him. They tried to portray him as very dangerous.
How has it changed? No,
I just, my reading is that the media had always lampooned him and I think the fact that the numbers speak, no, the numbers speak. If people have seen the Congress as an alternative, look at the seats
I
they
don't,
have.
I okay. Let
so
me challenge.
He's
you.
Not a pappu.
Let
sorry.
Me challenge. Okay, no one
he's
second.
A,
I
out
I'm
and
not
out pappu.
No, no. One second. I'm not commenting on whether he's a pappu or not, but I am okay. And I'm going to make a contentious statement. The votes that the BJP has lost was out of anger. The votes that have gone to the Indy Alliance is not a positive vote. It's a negative vote of the BJP, no. Which has
whatever
that's
the reason.
True. That's not true.
Whatever the reason.
I think a lot
in,
of people...
In Maharashtra, do you think there was a positive voting in favor
the
of the
amount
yes,
of time
and Congress.
Energy...
For Congress.
And in UP?
In UP, the SC, the meltdown of the...
It
the
was
meltdown
a negative
of the BSP.
Vote for
no,
the...
No, no, no. The meltdown of the BSP is a major factor.
Yeah, the meltdown
major.
Of the BSP as...
It's a single
Abhijit
major
explained
factor.
Right in the beginning...
It's a single biggest.
One factor. Second. The meltdown of the BSP should have ideally gone to the BJP.
Which the BJP expected.
Yeah.
But kudos to Akhilesh. Another
no, no, no. It's kudos to Akhilesh. It
look
is
at the
partly
this fear factor.
This is anger and reservation.
You do not vote for your oppressor unless there is anger. He's your in-your-face oppressor, right?
But
and notice today that news item that came out. In 16 seats, Mayawati saved the BJP because her vote share was... So it would have come down. They got, what, 40 in...
They would have been down
they
to 20.
They would have been worse.
They would have been down to 20.
But Smita, look, had the same combination that Akhilesh done, Amit Shah done, he would be called a Chanakya. You got to give Akhilesh the credit of making a broader combination,
no,
taking it beyond you, you
not,
other than Muslim.
Look, I'm
look,
not,
for the, no,
I'm not saying that
let
you
finish.
Don't give him credit.
Let me finish. So, for the Dalit vote to even come, the non-Jata vote to come to the SP, a party that has looked to have oppressed Dalits, he has made a broadband coalition, assured people that he's gone beyond YM factor, and that's why it's come.
No,
Tejasvi is trying that in Bihar.
So he has tried it. It hasn't really worked for Tejasvi, has it?
Oh, Tejasvi will be chief minister next time. I will give it to you.
Chief
now.
Minister to koi bhi ban jayega.
Koi bhi ban jayega.
Aap bol do
Mrs. Kejriwal. Sorry. No, no, Mrs. Kejriwal.
Hamare zamane mein, hamare lifetime mein, sirf Nitish Kumar prime minister, chief minister banega of Bihar.
Pata nahi.
Prime minister.
Is it a possibility?
Uske naseeb mein dekho yaar, kitna, matlab, how many lives? 9 lives, 15 lives, 25 lives.
But is it possible Nitish ji continues to be in centre? With the NDA and then state goes with them because they are winning.
No, I'm not. Nitish will be the crux. I don't feel so. See, if they got 295, Nitish got 12. Usko bhi agar aap hata do, 281. So the crux is TDP.
The crux is TDP.
Yeah. Both of them are
special,
important.
And special status for Andhra and
special status in they wanted in 2018, right? That's when he walked out. The India of 2018 and the India of 2024 is completely different.
Manifesto
And Chandrababu Naidu will, if he can get convinced easily, he's a futuristic kind of a person, right? What he did for Hyderabad, nobody has done it. Maybe, you know, you can think of Bangalore at one point of time and what it became.
And S.M. Krishna.
Right? S.M. Krishna. But what he wants is for Amravati. Amravati did not. YSR completely finished it, right? So now when you're talking about Chandrababu Naidu, he has a futuristic plan. If he can be convinced that you will get FDI, you will get semiconductor unit khol denge tumhare, what else does he need? So wo mereko lagta hai futuristic hai. Both Nitish
he's
and...
He's going to build Andhra Pradesh like
think,
no other state. It's
exactly,
like Chandigarh for him.
Yeah. And Nitish...
He's the one who blank slate. What is Telangana today? Yeah.
Nitish and Chandrababu Naidu, ye jo sare TV channels chala rahe na, they want finance, they want this ministry, that ministry. I doubt it. I think what they want is...
a smooth relationship with the center, right. whereby the funds come in and they are not hassled and they are helped.
Is there a common minimum program?
Is there a common minimum program?
They will not be at this stage. I doubt there will be a common minimum program.
Because yesterday the BJP spokesperson was saying there is an NDA common minimum program.
There is an NDA common minimum program, but that has special status.
Yeah.
Is there one? Can you forward me that?
Look, see, as far as I am concerned, a demand for a special status is neither here nor there. Right? It's in a, from Chandrababu Naidu's point of view, it's a legitimate demand, right? He needs to develop.
Andhra lost a lot. And
I think that's a very small price to pay. Look, in coalitions, you will have to make these kind of compromises. That's a small price to pay. Problem will come in on if you start demanding certain things which are not really doable. For example, bring in the old pension scheme. That's the best way to bankrupt the country. Okay? I have no problems if you reform the Agnivir scheme. In fact, I have been saying it. We've spoken about it. And I've told you many times that
they have to reform it.
They have to reform it. Now, there are multiple formulas for reforming it. You can, instead of 4 years, make it 7, 8 years, 9 years. In fact, I was told that initially the army had suggested to make it 8 to 9 years, right? People reject. And this is the other problem. When you start riding roughshod over every alternate opinion, then, you know, people say, okay,
so
fine,
this
karlo
is
jo
the
karna
change
hai.
That...
ek minute. Yeh Agnivir wala pe na, is very important.
Nee, but Agnivir, ek minute. Agnivir mein changes and all that, that everybody, like now JDU has said that change leke aao. But if Agnivir was such an issue, look at Himachal, look at Uttaranchal, Uttarakhand. They both have given... and from here, every family sends a soldier. Every family sends to...
Smita,
so there is
to win an election,
I think BJP will
you don't have to get everything.
To
win an to lose an election, you have to get some things wrong.
So
to win an election, you have to get everything
there is,
right.
Like if Agnivir was an issue in Uttar Pradesh or if Agnivir is an issue in Bihar, not necessarily an issue in Himachal and in Uttarakhand. So this is what I'm saying. Ek Samvidhan is an issue somewhere. Reservation hataenge somewhere. It's not an issue.
Yeah, okay,
so this
we are a diverse country.
Yeah,
but I do
so
think Agnivir is an issue.
No, diverse country where now 2019 there was no diversity. Everybody agreed on Pulwama and Balakot. No. So
I think everybody blows it out of proportion. No. That election was not about Pulwama and Balakot.
Exactly.
It added a bit of a bump to the BJP. That election was about the
continuity
the
of
welfareism
Modi.
Of Mr. Modi. And you can win one election on welfareism. It's difficult to win the second election on the same welfare
like
scheme.
UPA.
Without substantial development.
UPA did well. Wait, I'm going to come one by one now because otherwise everybody is like talking over each other. I'm going to come to you, Anand, about when we are talking about welfareism. So let me continue with that. Then I'll come to you about dynasty. Welfareism, do we see the end of it or do we see more of welfareism? Because welfare has become now something you have to do. What do you think?
So, we will see much more of it.
Yeah.
And we should.
And yes, we should. Yeah. My only problem out there is that, you see, socialism, which is welfareism, is only possible in a capitalist society. You need to generate money in order to distribute it or spend it. I don't think this government, the new government, is going to take any tough decision. They are not going to go for privatization. They are not going to go for all those decisions that are important, agricultural reform, so many things that are going to catapult our economy to a middle-income economy. Our labor force, for example, 44% of it, 580 million, is involved in agriculture. Yeah. So obviously, we can't be an economic power without any reform whatsoever that is required. On the other hand, I think even though, so there are two things out here. Let me split it. So you basically, the two biggest coalition partners are Nitish and Chandrababu Naidu. Nitish is a master or will demand social engineering. Naidu has been the pioneer of economic boom and all those. So the partnership of Naidu and Modi will be very good for India. It will give it a very stable government. Modi already was spending, five times more in terms of fiscal infusion, capital infusion than UPA ever did. 12 lakhs, 13 lakhs, you know. So despite keeping the fiscal deficit to 85% or something else. So that augurs very well. What pains me, it does, because I wrote a book on it, all those important issues that would have been important, critical, to remove discrimination against Hindus are now out of the window. So Waqf Act will continue, Place of Worship Act will continue, temples will remain under state control, RTE Act will continue. Everything that Hindus want for India to prosper in the long run, okay, is out of the
Give
window
me a clarification.
Now. Yeah.
Are the temples which are under state control a state subject
or a state subject?
Absolutely. So state governments can remove it?
No, but the reason state governments never remove it is because, for example, in Maharashtra,
it's a revenue earning.
Not just, forget the revenue. Your loyalist gets adjusted there. So there are actual meetings between coalition partners on who's getting chairmanship of which trust.
That's not the reason. The biggest problem is why temples. I know for a fact the BJP was ready to do it. Then you had this whole thing where they started justifying exclusion on the base of caste, saying group rights, and the BJP just did a 180. They're very clear. If we do that, and it ends up in this group rights leading to exclusion of birth-based exclusion for temples, that is the end of Hindutva. You're finished. It can't be done. And it should not be done. I completely agree with exclusion based on menstruation in Sabarimala. I completely agree with exclusion of men from Kamakhya while the goddess there is menstruating. I completely agree with both men and being
That's a traditional thing. That is
from Kutandava temple because it's meant to be a transvestite only temple. This is different. This is caste-based discrimination.
Cannot be
traditional
allowed.
Or not, I don't give a shit about your tradition.
It cannot be
You allowed. Can't do that. Full stop.
I agree.
Shove your tradition. End of story. Okay? That said, I would disagree with Anand on what he just said. I think they will actually be much more focused on economic reforms.
That's what I said.
And possibly
but
even...
But welfareism will increase
also on social reforms. Today, Janata Dal United has come out supporting UCC and One Nation, One Election. Okay? They've come out. They've actually said that. I think Modi, being the shark that he is, he needs to keep swimming, otherwise he'll sink. He now realizes that he needs real reforms. Last time, you know, 370 was fantastic, Ram Mandir was fantastic, but how did it affect the people? Zero. He needs reforms on the ground that affect people. So you need all of these things like industrialization. Industrialization, hard jobs.
Yeah. Which jobs. Look at the crowds that came for Akhilesh. Those are unemployed.
Which is why I'm saying the data shows 18 to 25, 26 to 32 have overwhelmingly, with a 10 percentage point, which is huge, voted for the India Alliance. Now, that is something that should spook the BJP because young voters were BJP.
They need jobs. How do you get jobs without
the election data as well as the exit poll data?
Yeah. It's not right. Now he's suddenly believing exit poll data.
No, I'm not. But I also believe that the youngsters were voting for this.
When we're talking about jobs, let me just tell you this one thing. I saw this one show by Sandeesh. Some of you may not like him as a YouTuber, but I saw his show on a Dalit village. I cried when I saw that.
I did too. It was terrible.
He spoke to this young kid, you know, probably 14 or something.
Desh Premi.
Yeah. What's your name? He said, my name is Desh Premi. He said, when did you last eat? He said, yesterday. How much do you get to eat 2 meals a day? He says, mang ke khata hu, mang ne se do, nahi to ek. He eats 1 meal a day.
Which is why giving rations is so important.
And he said that the other village, they're not allowed to use the water in that village. So Sandeesh walks with him to his house, poverty-stricken village. Then he speaks to another one, the villager, slightly more prosperous in comparison, right? And he says ki is village mein aushadhi kendra bana tha. So he said, oh, okay, so you have an aushadhi kendra. He said, nahi, because there is some Buddhist stupa or something like that. I'm not exactly remembering the thing. And he said a couple of years ago, some Korean had come here and they wanted to worship out here. So unhone aushadhi kendra banaya. Na state government ne banaya, na center ne banaya. Some foreigner came and usne banaya. You know, when you see that, then you really rethink
it shakes you up.
That in this country you still have persecution of this nature ki pani nahi pee sakte dusre gaon mein, that khana mang ke bhi tum do meal nahi provide kar sakte, so that anaj matters. And now you know, in
and you know, the comfort in all of this is meant to be the British brought in caste. It wasn't Indian.
I don't know. No,
yeah, I don't care who brought it in.
It's
staring us in the face.
It's staring us in the face.
I think
what? So you know, there's only one sort of denialism.
One second. Meko ek cheez bata. Dekho, you know, a smart political player will also learn from the campaigns of his adversaries. And if the campaign from the adversary was on three issues, one was unemployment, of course, which of course
is a real issue,
is a problem. The second one was about poverty, but you were trying to address the poverty question. It's, you know,
linked
you can throw,
to caste.
One second. You can throw data that we picked up, and you, and I'm not surprised that you must have picked up. But the fact of the matter remains, there is that level of economic distress. Yes. And then the inequality factor. I was talking to Anand when we came in, and I was saying that after COVID ended, one of the statistics which has been doing the rounds is, and I'm dumbing it down, right? But it's about cars being sold.
Correct.
Cars being sold. And what the statistic shows is that the growth in the rupee 10 lakh plus cars has zoomed.
Zoomed. And the
3 to 5, 6 lakh small car, which is like the middle class guy, has dipped.
Declined. Dipped completely.
This should have been a warning signal.
Correct. It should have.
Right? That people from a certain income bracket are not buying those cars. Even cannot buy those cars.
The first person to point this out was Kushan Mitra. Not just that, also scooters.
No,
scooters
just about
and
airlines. Let me tell you about airlines also.
Let Anand complete. Okay. Then you go.
Okay. So, we have to interrupt
this.
I am going to interrupt.
Sushant looks like my daddy.
Shut up.
He's a daddy.
Stop interrupting.
First of all, on the, you know, what you mentioned and what he mentioned, so I won't take long. You see, anecdotally, India is a land of stories that are so heartrending.
Yeah.
So, of course, there is abject poverty. Of course, there is unemployment. There's hundreds of issues.
Yeah.
And the fact is that in the last 70 years, every month, every week, you can make a documentary which would be heartrending. I'm not trying to berate it. Mm. What I'm saying is, has the situation improved? It might not have improved dramatically. Has it improved? Yeah, are we going in the right direction?
Correct. Yeah, yes.
You don't have people dying of hunger.
No, what I'm saying is, welfare measures have to increase. We were talking about welfare measures. So, isliye maine kaha that BJP government will have to increase that 5 kilo to maybe 5 kilo chini, 5 kilo dal, make it
so,
more.
Yes.
They have to.
So statistics points to the fact that we are doing better than we did 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years, 20 years ago. That's one. My problem always remains the speed with which we are improving. I obviously believe it's not enough because we haven't taken the reforms, we haven't taken the tough decisions. Now I come to what Paji has said. That statistics is not quite right, Paji, because India sold the most vehicles ever in its history, 4.1 million vehicles last year. And most of them were actually below 4 lakhs. So scooties, two-wheelers, cars that are below the thing, you are absolutely right that the percentage increase in buying high value cars increased because of low base also. So if you have, you know, two people buying cars, then next time 10 people buy luxury cars, so percentage wise increase. But the fact is, majority of the 4.1 million vehicles sold are belonging to the people who are buying it less than 4 lakhs, less than 3 lakhs.
Okay, there are two issues out here.
And lastly on jobs, if I may say so. You have the periodic labor force survey, you have the labor bureau data, you have the national sample survey. All of them are pointing to the fact, in fact, Karan Basin and Mr. Bhalla and Niti Aayog have come up with this, that 85 million jobs were created from 2014 to 22. Now, you can dispute it. Congress disputes it. Everyone.
Okay, 85 nahi hoga, 60 hoga.
Point is, are we going in the right direction? Yes, we are. But are we going fast enough?
Yeah.
No, we aren't.
Right. See, but the point is not just about statistics. The point is also about lived reality.
Absolutely.
Right? So if people are feeling that jobs are not there,
then you have to उसका इलाज क्या है?
No, feeling अलग बात है,
माहौल आ गया
फिर. अच्छा, industrialization करना है. हाँ, तहसीन को बोलने दो.
So one of these things about this automobile data, which is seriously flawed, is the data that you quote, and he's right here, is what factories are dumping in showrooms. Is that from showrooms being converted to the last man? That's not happening. That's happening only in high-end cars. Even the airline travel, that's increased massively. That they say the highest airline travel ever happened post-COVID, the pent-up demand. 50% of that travel is by 1% of India.
Exactly.
1% of India. I travel four times a week on airlines. Four times a week. Now, that's I'm even less
I can't afford an airline travel anymore.
It's prohibitively gone up.
And I only travel business
off one. It's acting like a gift and good.
So now,
the higher it's going up, the more it's...
You missed the snobbery.
Yeah, now the third part. And so imagine that 1% mein I'm cream. Now imagine, and you're saying, now you look in this, this data's, he's right, it's misleading. Now come to the third part, even on the food thing and what you said about welfare. India is not the most hungry country in the world. It's not at all hungry. It's the most malnourished country in the world. Please understand the difference between the two. Yes, we are giving 5 kg ration to 80% of the people. What are you giving in ration? You're giving carbohydrates. Mm. That has led to severe malnutrition crisis, a severe cardiac arrest crisis,
yes.
And the government is gloating over it without realizing the heart attack pandemic you've created. You understand biology, you understand science. We are, our children are skidding. Our children, we are not the tallest country in the world. In fact, our average height where other countries have increased has reduced. Giving carbon, severely stunting. And I'm saying this as a father of a newborn child, right? Why should my son, honestly, have more advantage than a poor person's child? Because our kids get protein. Unless we don't bring in protein. If you want to do true welfareism, bring in protein. But what this government has done is this cut, copy, paste. And that is not just creating a have versus have-nots. It's creating a young India that is not going to be not be able to reap in the benefits of the economic growth.
Can I push back?
Please.
Just very quickly. Your party is also responsible for
that. Of course.
They raised a pointless, instead of focusing on protein,
egg. Focused went on egg.
Bhai, how does it matter how you get your protein?
Yeah.
And your nutrients. Nobody's talking about nutrients.
True.
You know, nutrients you can get with multivitamin tablets, which are not perishable, that can be given.
Arey, vegetable, yaar. Grow vegetables.
See, vegetables still cost.
It's coming.
Cost of cooling, transporting, sad jata hai.
Karo.
Multivits do not.
People are not growing vegetables also.
One second, let
me finish. Because it's
not. Protein, there are 100 different ways. Yeah. Today you have a flourishing dairy industry, whey protein nikal ke do. Unlike soy, which leads to estrogenation, whey protein does not.
And give
you have to give them, you consolidate, make it whey tablets, make them, don't give them their daily meal till they swallow their
immunization.
Exactly, why karo?
Unless you don't do this, how will our country prosper? This is the welfareism we need. Mm. You're going to have a labor force that's not going to be equipped to handle, and without your protein requirement being met, and our protein requirement even in the middle class is so low, because what are we eating? Burgers, pizzas, etc. Where is our protein being consumed in the country? That is the problem. That is the welfareism nobody's talking about.
So welfareism is going, should, I don't know whether it is going to, welfareism will have to morph from just giving anaj.
Yes.
It has to go beyond
specific
than what we are doing.
We used to criticize Jean Drez for his carbohydrate-based food security model. And yet what we have done is, we've only implemented Jean Drez's carbohydrate model. We haven't moved past that fellow's, that toxic fellow's carbohydrate obsession into nutrients and proteins.
Achha, ab main toxicity ki baat karti hun, that about social media. Right?
By the way, I need to come in here in your support. That you interviewed that the guy who had a forest for a brow. I forget his name. Lawyer.
Kapil Sibal.
Ah, Kapil Sibal. Yes, yes, yes. if brow sweats, you can't. It disappears down his forehead. But anyway, and he disputed what you said, that Muslims are not worse off that thing, and that went viral. Oh, pata nahi.
Yeah.
You were right. The there National is, Family Health Survey.
Data. He never gave any data. Yaar. He was there just is saying, data. No, I'll give you the data. I'll give you
there
the
is data that proves data. You are right. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
No, but to say that Muslims are worse off than Dalits. Now, just because he's a lawyer and he can shout me down and he's the guest and I am the host, I just let him have the say. And then that, wo cut clip karke trolling hua mera. That, Kapil Sibal has...
Cut clip wala karta hi rehta. That cut clip,
she has been schooled and she has been... The point is that when you turn around and say ki Muslim ka halat is worse than the worst of Dalits, how are you coming... What has... Where is the data to prove that Is it the Ranganath Commission?
There is data they did to disprove survey. It. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. You so see, there is so no survey which has been carried out to prove this. So no commission
the latest
has
National
done.
Family Health Survey, I think Harsh Madhusudanan brought that very nicely, proves it that Muslims are better off than Dalits.
You know, so
inke man mein jo bhi aaye bolo aur keh do nahi nahi, you are wrong.
Like he was building up on the EVMs. If you notice, he was the one who was carrying out this muhim ki EVM. When the result comes out, you better watch out and all. Ab wo kahan hai?
But one credit to Tehsin, you never doubted the EVMs.
So I must put it on record, I am the only person who's challenged the EVMs, but that's not to remove
that is
it.
Because you are a serial litigator.
No, not because of that. I believe
yeah, EVMs kar lo ke le ro pehle ye bata do.
Achha, last election mein to you said last Samosa caucus you said you'll stand for election, wo hua nahi. Theek hai, ab
Priya hona chahiye tha.
Ab Vadra ji Rajya Sabha se jana chahte hain.
I hope he does.
He wants to go Vadra's.
Really?
Rob.
That's what
he wants. That's what he
can
said.
Both,
that
can both husband and wife go to parliament?
Yeah, why not? Yeah, so now which constituency is Rahul going to give up?
Wayanad.
I think if politically he should give up Wayanad, keep Rae Bareli because Congress has gained in Uttar Pradesh and Priyanka ji should contest from Wayanad.
Why Priyanka come into Rae Bareli?
Why should she because pick up something which has been rejected by Rahul?
Because it's I not, think now that you have two Gandhis, because, one should represent the north, one should represent the south.
And also, Kerala, there's elections next year. So, you will need a Gandhi factor there. Otherwise, Kerala will be
But
upset.
They won very big in Kerala. Yeah,
they won very big. So, they'll have to keep... So, at least PGV can come in from Kerala.
Explain to me, Rae Bareli and Amethi, her face wasn't on the ticket, but she won that election in both the places, right?
Not for the first time.
And it's she who did everything.
She did everything.
And she has worked ceaselessly from there and she has still to pick up his reject.
No, she's not picking up his reject. You always knew that he had to give up one seat. I don't even know if she's going to contest or no. I am giving my political opinion that if he does, I would like to see Priyanka Gandhi Vadra in parliament and by the Lok Sabha route. So Wayanad is a good seat because there's Kerala elections.
Listen, is it, Abhijit, do you feel this whole attacking of this, Vanshwad hai, political dynasty? I think it's a done and done. In India, it doesn't matter anymore.
Look,
people
don't
care.
The point is, the Congress can elect whoever the hell they
Whether
want.
Whether Congress or anyone, other party.
Okay. The Misa point
Bharti
is,
won, right?
How does it matter if they ultimately have to go to the people for validation?
Yeah.
Right. If the people want Vanshwad, to do, kya zabardasti unko nikal doge Vanshwad se?
Yeah.
And so, BJP has got so many first generation dynasts.
Haan, bilkul. So I
understand their academic argument.
See, my criticism of the Gandhis has to do with their political and social vision. It has nothing to do with who their parents are. Does it jar every now and then the sense of entitlement? Yes. But if it doesn't jar with their voters, then who the hell am I to object about it? Where you come from should not be a determinant of what you can do. It applies to the lowest of the Dalit. It also applies to the highest of the Gandhi. Okay? Where you come from should not be the determinant of the opportunity you get.
That was the chair.
You know, we were talking about Agniveer, whether that should be modified or not. You said that, yeah, okay, make a change.
Make changes. No, you can't bring back the old recruitment system simply because you cannot afford it.
Okay, but
it's not been scrapped though.
What? No, no,
the
no.
The old recruitment system. No, it's not. It's not been scrapped. That's the problem. That is the other problem.
Like, are you saying there are two parallel systems?
Yes, and no, they say, no, exams hoga, permanent hoga, ye to temporary hai.
Nahin.
Abhi check kar lo Google pe.
Achha, old ek Agniveer hai.
Exams nahi kiya hai.
Dusra I want to know is that will 3.0 Modi see any change in our foreign policy? Do you think there'll be any changes?
There are a couple of things. And I wrote about this also. I think the message has gone down. He will continue to look for better relations with the West. But I think I would caution them on how far to go with the West. Because he has been stabbed in the back.
Mm. Yeah.
They deny interfering and meddling in the election, but the Western countries have interfered and meddled in the
Shans
election.
Transparently
big time,
interfered.
Big time.
Governments.
Right? Governments have done
we're
it.
We're not talking
through
about...
Through their media.
Yeah.
No, through their media and through their these front organizations. Right?
Big tech.
not big tech. I'm talking front about these foundations.
He's talking about.
They have interfered and meddled big time.
But they can say non-state actors.
They will, whatever they say.
No, no, they all get funding from the governments. You can prove the line of funding.
They went aggressively after Bangladesh.
Even after Bangladesh. So I think he will continue to look for closer relations.
But
I think
he spoke about it.
And Prime Minister Modi supported her. And that's where my respect for the Prime Minister.
He backed her all
and that's where my respect for him really. This is our most important neighbor. Forget all the...
So one second.
But India...
So one, he will look for that. But I think he needs to be a lot more careful and cautious about the Western. Because, you know, frankly, the perfidious Albion... is still a perfidious Albion, right? Secondly, on his neighborhood first, I think he's proven it already. He's already called, but he's left out the Pakis.
But just a second, should Shahbaz Sharif have been invited? Considering the chemistry as in Nawaz Sharif, asking.
No.
I'm for not inviting.
Because frankly speaking, there is nothing positive happening in Pakistan. Although I suspect there will be a lot more pressure on him. Partly because of the kind of results that have been thrown up both in Punjab as well as in Kashmir. And I think that is a very disturbing thing. So
Trudeau government.
The opposition's quite...
If you think the opposition's going to be any friendlier to you, think again. They are both vying now for the Khalistani
vote. That's true. He's right on
you
this.
Look at the right-hand man of Pierre Poilievre. It's a guy called Tim Uppal.
Who's just made a statement.
Jagmeet and Trudeau are Bindranwale's right testicles. This guy is the left testicle of Bindranwale.
Honestly.
So thank God there are only two testicles.
Yeah. We don't know.
What hangs?
So let's not be...
Stop.
Have people forgotten how the UPA government literally boycotted Stephen Harper's reception when he was Prime Minister? Because he, as a conservative, was trying to build bridges to the Khalistanis, which they had avoided for the longest time.
And it's a right-wing conservative.
It is a right-wing conservative. Trudeau's so, we need to remember, Khalistanis are very, very tactical in Canada. They know how to promise and shift support and shift votes and things like that. Very, very well.
And look, this election has proven one thing. That this denial that we have been living in, that Khalistan is a problem only in Canada and other
it's
places.
It's there here now.
It's very much... Look, it's been there. It's been staring...
Amritpal state
forget
has
Forget Amritpal.
Amritpal state has
listen,
Golden
nahin,
Temple.
That's all nonsense. You know, no nonsense. Don't make these conspiracy theories.
I'm telling
you. Prove kar. Dekh, aise hai.
Kaise prove kar?
It has been... one second. Tehsin, this problem has been staring us in the face for the last 5 years at the very minimum. We have been talking about it on this show. Yeah. I've been telling you it's getting worse and worse.
Yeah.
You are seeing it staring at you in the face.
Yeah.
You are seeing manifestations of it on the streets of Punjab.
I agree with you.
And yet, you know, you are standing up and saying, nahin, kuch nahin, mujhe kuch nazar nahin aa raha kyunki maine aankhein band kar rakhi hain.
You know, Abhijit, what Sushant is saying is exactly like if you go into the interiors, or not now, but if you went into the interiors of Tamil Nadu, you saw Prabhakaran's hoardings, right? So for us from the north, when you go there and you see Prabhakaran's hoarding, we are a generation which has seen Rajiv Gandhi's assassination. I mean, in the sense that we've lived through that period. So for us, it's a shock.
But we need
and
to remember.
And this is what happens Smita, in
so,
Punjab.
This guy is much younger.
It will metastasize very differently, because I remember as a kid I went into LTT training camps that Indira and Rajiv were running in Cuddalore. My mother was the collector of Cuddalore. Most of those training camps were, in fact, in her district. I've been into those training camps that Indira Gandhi was silently running and Rajiv Gandhi took over. Right?
You were rejected.
I think... Huh? Yes, I was rejected.
Lose some weight. Alas.
No, I was too fair, apparently.
So, my God, but, you Sam Pitroda.
To add to what he's saying, you see, now Labour is coming to power in UK.
Mm. That's true.
So, this Khalistani thing...
And the Kashmiri thing.
Yeah, it's going to get worse.
What
did you see there?
My things are very... This thing. All I remember was these really nice guys. They were sweet, very polite, fantastic.
All Tamilians.
I don't remember. I hadn't discovered my sexuality.
All the millions are very nice and polite.
Are you get to the point.
Yeah.
Seedhe point pe aa unna.
Both Khalistan and Kashmir will metastasize differently than they did. Don't look at it as going the same path that they did. What Khalistan has become is an organized crime racket.
Mm.
remember, both Kashmir and both the Kashmir insurgency and the Punjab insurgency happened as a result of the Green Revolution and massive fertility rates of 5, 6 and 7 in Kashmir and Punjab. Today, your fertility rate is under replacement rate. It's 1.4 and 1.6.
True.
That's such an important point. It's like Latin America now.
Yeah.
It'll be ruled by gangsters. So it'll be like it's not going to go in insurgency.
What is going to happen is Khalistan is already... This Khalistan title is a front for organized crime, gun running, drug running. Which is why Udta Punjab is what? It is a drug running racket that needs Khalistan as a slogan to give it political legitimacy.
Yes, the way
Pablo Escobar required to run for parliament in order to give his drug business legitimacy. Right.
He kabhi kabhi itna gyani hota
hai. And he got caught because of a picture. So one photo of his got him caught.
Kabhi kabhi.
One photo.
See? No, in the sense that it gets overshadowed by your other personality.
But why should
blue,
I be...
Blue moon.
See, like an election, like he said, no election is monocausal, it's multi-causal. Why can't I have a multifaceted personality?
You do continue, then...
So what happens here is, we need to understand what we're looking at is not an insurgency problem in Punjab. It is going to be a severe...
Narcotics problem.
It is going to be a drug mafia problem.
Please understand this.
Which you will not be able to solve because they will wrap themselves up in the political legitimacy of Khalistan. In Kashmir, I don't yet see how it's going to metastasize. The good thing, of course, is Mehbooba, Omar, and all the...
Rashid, engineer, he's in jail. I'm coming to that.
Rashid won. Why? Because the people who want separatism are now rejecting the sort of soft... Remember, all of these people were Pakistani stooges. Whether we like it or not, Omar Abdullah is a Pakistani stooge. Mehbooba Mufti is a Pakistani stooge.
I don't know.
They would always say what Pakistan wanted you to say, which was Pakistan is a stakeholder.
I'll stand for
Pakistan is a stakeholder. Talk to them.
Are you not talking track to them, Pakistan, even
no,
today?
No, you're not. And you should not. Because that is all they wanted. All they wanted was
Pakistan.
The legitimacy of talks.
I think Pakistan...
One second, let me finish.
Tehsin, let me finish.
I don't know how it is going to metastasize in Kashmir, but the election of Rashid shows you that they now... Either the soft separatism is finished, but there is a certain core element which wants Rashid-style hard separatism. Again... The fertility rates can't support an insurgency anymore. But what was keeping the insurgency on was the kind of conflict economy that we had sort of germinated out.
Fertility rates of?
Kashmir and
of
Punjab.
Kashmir.
1.4 and 1.6. Kashmir is one of the lowest fertility rates.
Let me just quickly finish this. It is going to metastasize. Punjab, we know exactly how it's going to metastasize into a sort of drug cartel mafia thing wrapped in political legitimacy. Kashmir, give us another 2-3 years and we'll see. They've not hit upon the formula yet of how to metastasize, but it will.
Anand, I'm going to come to you to ask you, what did you feel when you saw peaceful elections happening in Kashmir? I just felt good. You know, compared with West Bengal, people stood in line. Yeah, so did I on TV. I said violence in Bengal, but peaceful polling in Kashmir. Whatever the results, I don't care what the results are. Peaceful polling, people believing that their vote matters, getting there without fear or favor, getting there and casting their vote, having faith in Indian democracy. I just felt good about it. What did you feel as an Indian?
40% plus?
I don't know what is it that I'm just stunned by. Stunned in a negative sense, like, you know, animal is stunned by an injection of antibiotic or whatever. I have for the last 10 years, 15 years, I'm absolutely not enthused by Kashmir at all. I don't want to visit it. I don't want to sometimes even talk about it because all our policies, cutting across governments, have failed us Indians, starting with the Kashmiri Hindus, of course, cutting across party lines. And also this thing about 16 million Indians or tourists visiting Kashmir last year. You're giving it a facade that everything is fine, including these lines, but you're not acting on what should be done. So it is just a facade.
There's a tension below the surface.
So it can erupt at any moment.
The failure
if you haven't rehabilitated 7 lakh Kashmiri Hindus,
let him finish and then I'll come to Tehsin and Sushant, as
Sushil Pandit and other Kashmiri Hindus also say, all this money, millions, perhaps billions that has been minted out of 16 million tourists going there, is all going to, mostly going to terrorists. You know, and then this whole insurgency and whatever you may call it, terrorism, militancy, or whatever face you may like to address it as, is going to continue. You need an Israel-like solution.
Israel
to Kashmir.
Israel
exactly.
Israel
come exactly. Se come, exactly. Come, you see, no,
that is the worst suggestion, Anand.
Worst suggestion.
Exactly. Okay, wait, wait, one by one. Let, finish, let him finish, okay, sorry, and then. Please,
the fact that Israel has not been able to quote-unquote solve it is not because Israel not acting to solve it or Israel not doing things that should be done. If, for example, 7 lakh Israelis were driven out of their homes and Israel had not acted, you would have said, haan, solve nahi kiya. Lekin Israel has catered for its people who were hard done by. We haven't. It's as simple as that. Despite that, yes, there may never be a solution because of the ideology of the people who hate Israelis and the ideology of the people who hate Hindus. That's irrespective. What I'm saying is, have we taken the right decisions? We haven't.
First okay, of all, wait, one by one. Let Tehsin go and then Sushant and then you.
In 10 years of having two of the most powerful men in the universe, Modi ji and Amit Shah ji as Prime Minister and Home Minister. 5 years Amit Shah ji as Home Minister.
Right?
I'm saying, I'm going to support them. Not one. I'm sarcastically
I'm saying,
रात में सोने से पहले मोदी जी मैंने खाना खाया मोदी जी की कृपा
मेरे भाई में से
बहुत ज्यादा कर दिया है
इन हिज डिफेंस ही डिडंट से मल्टीवर्स
नो देयर इज अ वर्ड व्हिच इज बीइंग यूज्ड बाय द ट्रोलर्स दे सेइंग चरण वंदना
चरण
वंदना दिस इज चरण वंदना
नो नो आई एम सेइंग इट सार्केस्टिकली डिस्पाइट अमित शाह जी बीइंग एज पावरफुल एज ही इज नॉट अ सिंगल पर्सन आउटसाइड ऑफ कश्मीर इज बॉट लैंड नॉट वन यू हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू नॉर्मलाइज इट यस आई एग्री विद हिम बेटर टूरिज्म एंड ऑल आई वेंट टू कश्मीर ट्वाइस How does that help? Where is the normalcy? What steps have been taken? Nothing. Come to
nothing
Punjab.
Nothing to nahi yaar.
Let me come to Punjab. 50, 50 something that really bothers me. And again, as a young father, he's right. The drug problem is not, don't just look at it as a narcotics problem. Some of my best friends are serving in narcotics. He's met one of them at my birthday.
I thought you were saying some of my best friends are drug addicts.
No, be serious. They're serving narcotics. Which the problem is gone so, is yeah. so rampant. From Punjab, it's now entered Haryana, Gurugram, Delhi. You see, drugs are so easily available. It's completely, our entire younger generation is hooked on to drugs. It is freely available. People are doing lines in nightclubs, in restaurants, openly. Nobody gives a damn. It is what he's talking about, Pablo Escobar or the Kali cartel. Those cartels are right now in Gurugram. They are right now at the border supplying. And you know
really?
How
this? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It is worse. You have no idea what is happening in Delhi.
Schools and colleges.
Yeah. The government
in
has
Gurugram.
Yeah.
In Delhi. In
Chennai
Delhi,
has
in central,
a massive problem.
Gujarat.
It came up during the elections.
So it's not just Punjab.
No.
Punjab
no.
has been the catalyst.
I thought
from
it was Pune
came.
Where it was the big problem.
Pune too.
Pune, obviously, it is all of it. It's come all across the country. Now from Punjab. Obviously, it's coming in from Afghanistan, Pakistan to Punjab. That's the border. But from Punjab and Kashmir,
it's filtering all over the place.
It's filtering all over. And now this problem, because of these cartels that have been created, these local cartels, politically backed, I'm not giving any political party this thing, this problem has gone out of control. You're going to see our younger generation really get destroyed. You see these guys completely hooked onto it. And you know how they're buying it. And the government has no idea. Everything is it's all being bought on crypto in the dark web. How does the government know how to deal with dark web? It is open trading on the dark web. It's home delivery. Aapko 10 minute mein dawai nahi milegi, aapko 10 minute mein drugs mil raha hai. That is the problem. The first kid, if a kid is lost.
If you know this, why do you suppose that our intelligence agencies don't?
Some of the officers who are working in the NCRB, etc. Again, he's met one of my friends. They are trying their best. But unless you don't have institutional support from the government and it's taken seriously, but how does one officer, one department handle the entire dark web? What is our technology? We are not progressing there. With all of this happening, with now the advent of AI, where you can mask how you're buying it, with home delivery, if a child's kidnapped, before the police finds him or her, more chances that a drug mafia will find him. Within 15 to 20 minutes, a kidnapped child, lost on a railway station, will be picked up by the drug mafia. These are statistics nobody's talking about. What are we doing to our young generation? Nobody wants to discuss it, neither the government nor the opposition. And the drug problem in India is going to go out of hand. How does Pakistan destroy India's economy?
Hmm.
The best way to destroy it without firing a single bullet is to...
Like what they did with Punjab, the sword arm of India, and you go and destroy its
and
youth.
They've got, and now they've tasted success in Punjab.
Yeah.
And that led to the increase in radicalism.
Same thing is happening in Rajasthan.
In America,
Rajasthan,
the opiate crisis is supposed to be that.
But exactly. See, even basic things that the police can do, they do diddly squat. I had filed a police complaint, say, sometime in November. To date, nothing has happened. No guy in the police called up. They haven't taken any even
complained
rudimentary action.
Complaint.
Whatever.
Tha, coach. They send me a notice saying your case has been closed as per action taken. What action taken? Nothing. Now they want to come in, take my phone because apparently there's evidence in there. There's no evidence in there. So, tumhara police hi itna ghatiya hai, and we're talking about sitting in South Delhi. Yaar. This Safdarjung enclave police station itna ghatiya hai.
And you're a powerful known guy.
I'm a known
person.
No,
nothing happens. I get death threats, rape threat and all. Aap file karoge kya, case karoge kya, bahut musibat hai, ye to sabko hota hai. You know, so you say, to hell with it, yaar. Who's going to do it? So when these threat comes, you just for...
Understand the action on this.
Threatened me with...
One second.
Answer, Judha, when you
what?
The action on this.
Who's
this?
That Shoaib Jamai some...
You got a threat?
Yeah, openly.
You have to hear this joker show my story. But you want to finish, then I'll tell you.
Now, all it requires is one email being sent to Twitter asking to reveal the identity of XYZ. And then you send somebody from some other police station to pick the guy up. How much time does that take? Nothing. Karoge? Kuch nahi. Wo basically, and all they keep doing is sitting and drinking cups of tea and coffee in their office.
What happened with
and
yours?
And arresting
what?
People.
No,
I
need to,
wait, story,
what happened with yours?
So,
this was on air?
This was on Twitter.
Twitter.
Yeah. And I mean, his tweet, I think, is probably still there. And they were like, Abhijit also reacted to that. In the manner only Abhijit knows.
Why did I not see this tweet?
Yeah, he's, even I didn't
were blocked.
See.
And then he blocked.
Then he blocked.
He said Satan says you that too.
No. Well, I mean, so let me give you the background. Yeah. I was explaining the hypocrisy of the media and that they're scared of Islamists. It was an open threat and everyone tagged Delhi police and HMO and everyone. Even Tehsin did.
I did.
Yeah, Abhijit did.
I am under threat and my security is not because...
Nothing
of,
happened.
No, so my security is because these jokers, the Sar Tansi Juda jokers, have gone after me for supporting Nupur. Not the other way around.
Yeah.
And I have to tell you something about this character. This character is a very funny story. So when Shaheen Bagh protest was happening, I was invited to speak. And of course, I was anti-CA and I've gone to court. I went to Shaheen Bagh to speak. So this guy calls me, Bhaijan, suna hai jab aa rahe ho? He said, haan. Bhaijan, main aapko receive karta ho. Theek hai, main to, I don't want an entourage. Jala jao. Main hoon, sach hoon, main to entourage chahiye. Bula jao bhai, free mein aa rahe, kar rahe ho. He comes, he receives me outside the Shaheen Bagh thing, takes me to some coffee shop. Now, I have this whole group with me and I'm going. You know, I want to make my entry, you know. Suddenly, I see a commotion behind me. वहाँ की public इसको मपीट रही थी. क्यों? Because he was going on TV saying he's the spokesperson for Shaheen Bagh. Nobody knew him there.
And he was thrashed by a woman on panel live or so. Chappalon se. I forget.
That I don't know.
Okay, let's come back now to Kashmir where we were going.
So this guy threatened you.
So let's go with what is your view on Kashmir. Do you have the same kind of pessimism that Anand has?
See, I think
or my optimism.
NDA 2 or BJP 2 did a lot of good stuff in the sense scrapping 370, attacking the ecosystem, the financial networks. Not enough, but they at least started doing it. Trying to cleanse the bureaucracy, again, not enough, but nevertheless, at least efforts were being made. But the problem I have been flagging ever since is what you are doing right now, you cannot continue indefinitely. So you have
statehood,
to have
you have
to have a political alternative. Right? What is your political alternative? Jo inhone koshish ki koi apni party banai ye wo,
wo nahi bana.
It's all collapsed.
Correct.
Right? So you are literally left with zero political alternative. Now you suddenly have the Jamaat-e-Islami, the mothership of terrorism, coming out and that guy saying that look, if you take the ban away from us, we are ready to participate in elections. Now, the Jamaat is a party which changes its colors depending on what the mood is. Now, this does not mean that they've reconciled to the reality of India.
Exactly.
What it means is now they want to get the ban removed and re-enter the system and re-infiltrate the system.
Takiya.
Right? That's what they're wanting to do.
lot of people are very enthused. Oh, democracy is working, democracy. Democracy is not really working in Kashmir. Mm. It's good that, yes, elections happen peacefully and all of that.
Mm.
I would have wished, if given a choice between an engineer, Rashid, or Omar Abdullah, I would have, of course, rooted for Omar Abdullah.
Hmm.
You know, as an Indian, yeah. I would obviously root. Yeah. I might have a lot of problems with positions he takes.
I agree with you.
But at the end of the day, I know that he doesn't have a future in Pakistan. That's even true. He knows it.
Yeah.
Right? The point is that you get a guy like Engineer Rashid, you have, I think it's warning bells which are ringing.
Hmm.
And somebody needs to wake up to the fact that what is your political alternative? Now, the police in Jammu and Kashmir, as long as it's a UT, you can control the police. The moment it becomes a state and policing goes under the state government and you have an elected state government, you go back to the old system that was happening where you were running with the hound and running with the hare and hunting with the hound. And
why didn't the BJP field any candidates in Kashmir?
Yaar, unko pata hoga ki humare paas koi zyada traction nahi hai, so maybe that's the reason. I would suspect that is the reason.
They lost Ladakh, which was anyways going to happen.
Yeah, look, Ladakh was a bit of a toss-up. And in any case, you know, the Buddhist road gets divided. So, but there Ladakh is a guy from Kargil who wins.
Ladakh wants autonomy again. It wants the schedules.
Yeah, look, you know, those are political demands. I don't have a problem with that, that people have those kind of political demands.
True.
They might want statehood for all I care.
They do, yeah. And which you is, must, and you have to give statehood.
I don't care. You know, no, that is not
has to be given.
No, no, listen, yaar, as far as I am concerned from a security point of
Why
view.
Why not? Why?
How can you take away statehood?
Yaar, 1 minute, soon. As from a
security... Puducherry ko state dene.
Kashmir or Puducherry, Jammu and Kashmir. How can you downgrade somebody from state?
He is talking about a serious law and order situation.
No, no, part of it is because statehood has been taken away.
But, yaar, 1 minute.
Absolutely. Sorry, you finish, I'll answer that.
Dekho, aise hai, there are some demands which are political demands. These are legitimate political. Correct. Whether it's in Darjeeling, whether it's in Ladakh, whether it's in one of these places, outlying areas think that, yaar, we are going to be ignored. If I'm a Darjeeling in a state like West Bengal, nobody gives a damn for me, right? But if I become a state in my own right, at least I get some things
exactly.
of my own. Now, that's a political issue. That's I can handle political agitation and all of that. The problem in the case of Kashmir, Ladakh is different in that sense. The problem in the case of Kashmir is it's not a political issue.
Yeah.
It's a security issue.
Yes.
Right? It's a national security.
Part of that is because of political mismanagement.
Now let me say
and
this.
One, part of that one thing I must clarify. This business that nobody from the rest of India has gone and bought land, that is because the law in Kashmir even exactly. now, the domicile law, says that, look, there is a certain way in which you can buy land out there.
Hmm.
1 second. Huh, that's the same law. That's the same law in places like Uttarakhand. That's the same Nagaland. Law in
370
many
ke
other places.
Do you remember the whole thing? Ke, oh, now everybody will come and take away your land and buy your land. Koi aaya? No, kuch hua?
Kuch nahi hua.
Kuch nahi. That's what Itna hawa. It's the same way as EBM.
Hmm.
Kuch hua? Kuch nahi hua.
But the
but
issue
Shmita,
the
nahi
politi-
hua?
The
drama,
politi-
yaar.
But
hona chahiye yaar.
But
why can't Indians buy land in Kashmir? At least the land that was originally of Kashmiri should be.
Why can't they buy agricultural land in Himachal? Do you support that?
No, no. They can buy land.
Agricultural land in Himachal?
Yes. 1 second.
Of course,
yaar,
I
ek
do.
Minute. They can.
If Priyanka Gandhi can have a house in
that's
Shimla.
That's not an agricultural land.
Yaar,
it's a holiday home.
Boss,
it's
not an agricultural hello, hello, hello.
Acha, okay.
Guys, if you want to go and buy land in Kashmir, you can still go even without meeting the domicile laws, provided there is certain. Usme kuch riders hain ki aap kuch invest
kar rahe hain. Riders ho, but any Indian should be able to buy land.
But no, but despite those riders, that's the point.
No, but that hawa jo machaya tha na, that oh Kashmiris won't be for Kashmir, people will come and take away everything.
But hawa ye bhi macha tha na ki
Ayodhya mein bhi yehi macha tha. When we were talking about what happened with Ayodhya, that oh you know we gave up our land and now these Gujaratis have come and they've taken same way in Kashi also, Varanasi also that. The boatmen have all gone. Nobody goes there because these big boats have come of Gujaratis.
Now, there are two aspects to this. One
this
is
paranoia
the fact
about outsiders. One, they're all Indians.
Hmm. So, there are two aspects to this. The first is, you had to show them that nothing's changed. But the second is for the Kashmiri Pandit's own safety right now, which is if they go back, when they started going back, they start getting shot.
Shot, yeah.
You need a longer state of normalcy wherein the insurgency goes completely down because these sleeper elements will always be there and 2-3 killings here and there. It doesn't require an insurgency.
Mm.
Will then wreck the return.
Yeah.
It requires 10 to 15 years of normalcy before the return happens. Okay. It's not a question of if, but a question of when that's going to happen. Number one. Number two, Anand, I keep going to Israel every year. Israeli policy is the worst counter-terrorism policy around. They have sorted out, we have successfully ended the Tamil insurgency, the LTT bombings and things like that out there. We've helped Sri Lanka end this thing. We have ended several insurgencies in the Northeast. Yeah. We have ended the Kashmir insurgency. We ended the Punjab insurgency.
Mizo.
Well, the Naxalites are still there, but their territory is largely reduced.
Yeah, left-wing terrorism.
For a country that has sorted out insurgency after insurgency after insurgency, to quote a country that hasn't sorted out a single goddamn insurgency, is this the worst solution?
Has there been an Islamic insurgency that has been ever?
Kashmir?
Whatever.
It's sorted out? It's
what do you mean sorted out?
Listen. The insurgency is over. Anand, the insurgency is over. Terrorism. What is the difference between terrorism and insurgency?
True.
Terrorism is sporadic incidents here and there. An insurgency is a continuous state of
terror. But Abhijit, to be terrorism.
Fair to Israel, the way we sorted it out, it was not as part of a very well thought out plan. We sorted it out by becoming a kind of a absorbent.
Softer, compromise.
And because we could afford to lose a lot of people.
Yeah.
Look at the number of... No, that's
that
a fact.
That sounds horrible.
You lost, it is no, true. You lost 30,000 people in bloody Punjab before you finally sorted it out, right? Before you finally got the balls to go and say that I am now going to get rid of all these bloody Khalistani elements.
What about Nagaland?
Ruthlessly. One second. In Nagaland and Mizoram and other places...
Can we do a salute
other places,
to KPS Gill?
Yeah, yeah, of course,
yes,
always.
Just recently was his
the entire Northeast, we lost a lot of people. Yeah. Lot of people over 20, 30 years before we finally managed to settle it down. Kashmir, how many people? 80,000 people?
Yeah.
Right? After which we finally managed to settle it. Itne mein to sari Israel ki population khatam ho jati hai, yaar.
Sure.
Yeah. So, they, you know, you can't have the same solution which we have,
but they
Israel.
Have not hit across any solution in the last 70 years.
Yeah, first, to bring this back into election, when we are talking about insurgency, we are talking about militancy and all that, did any consolidation, okay, we talked about mandalization of the vote that happened, right? In the sense, many are saying that this election is Mandal 3.0.
No,
right?
They were spooked.
Mandal, caste, and things have come back into play. Was there crystallization of the Muslim vote against BJP across the country? Was that, did that happen?
Happens. It always happens.
No.
But this time it was more.
Exactly. That's what I'm trying to say. Is no, that
because there was an alliance.
Yeah. Did they vote as
there
a group?
Vote cutting. Yeah.
Did they vote as a group for the India alliance? Because in many areas they're saying that the entire, this is where exit poll also went wrong. There is an article in Rediff which says that when people were asked, when the Dalit family was asked, ki tum kisko vote dene wale ho, bol do ki Modi ko vote dene wale, because those who come to you don't know agency ke log aa rahe, which means intelligence agency, ya pollster aa rahe, kaun aa rahe. So in many areas, whether they were Muslim or whether they were Dalits, they just said we are voting for Modi.
Sorry, but no disrespect, but you've taken me back to 1994 when you're quoting, there was an article in Rediff.
So it's come back, and I saw that it was strategic voting of the Muslims against BJP.
Smita, not just against BJP, Adhirandan Chaudhary, five-time MP, Yusuf Pathan, Bengali, Gujarati aya. और 85,000 वोटों से हरा के चला
बाहरी आउटसाइडर
देन ही इज नॉट एन आउटसाइडर
सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड
नाइदर इज शत्रुघ्न सिन्हा
हां
सो आल्सो वन
शत्रुघ्न सिन्हा आल्सो वन
खामोश
और कीर्ति आजाद
शत्रुघ्न सिन्हास कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी आसनसोल इज बॉर्डरिंग झारखंड एंड बिहार So it's actually a Hindi-speaking constituency in Bengal.
But hai to Bengal mein.
Of course, Bengal mein hai. But so, he was recontesting the
you
election.
You know, for a non-Bengali, I mean, they are so parochial, right, in Bengal, especially about its politics.
Culture, yeah,
and you know, they keep saying that, remember Mamata saying Nadda Gidda and all that? She used those terms.
And I think that is one of the things that the BJP did not comprehend in West Bengal. So there's tremendous loss in West Bengal.
BJP was a mess in Bengal.
They had zero idea. They just thought what they do in the rest of
who was in charge of Bengal in
Suvendu
BJP.
Suvendu Adhikari.
To be fair to Suvendu, I think understood it a lot better than those three jokers that were sent from the center the last time round.
Kailash Vijayvargiya.
But remember the
which
fear
were the jokers who were sent this time round?
They went. It was left to Suvendu. What had happened was the fear she had instilled.
And you never did anything.
I like the fact that you've normalized. Is baar kaun se joker bheje
the? Yeah.
Koi bhi bheje.
Inko samajh mein nahi aata Bengal.
But it is true, na? Bengal was a joke for BJP. What they've done is a joke.
Correct. The fear that Mamata Banerjee has put into the BJP cadre out there.
That we'll kill you if...
When the negatives are so tangible in your face...
This is what fascism really is.
Exactly.
But can I put an add to that? It's not that Mamata has put the fear. Yes, she has. But the inaction of the BJP to counter that fear is what is actually...
When they took the business jet to go to Calcutta the next day, or 2-3 days late, they are sitting in the business jet Dassault Falcon in plush chairs like this going...
Taking pictures.
Yaar, tumhare log mar rahe hain.
And where were they staying? Taj Bengal.
And they're sitting
in... Sandesh Khali had no impact at all on the election.
It would
she
have.
Won.
She won.
No, she won there.
So imagine the state of terror. You pick up one Shah Jahan Sheikh. What about all the other people?
Rekha Patra lost.
She lost.
Yeah.
But let me ask the BJP. If my cadre, like it's and you understand army. This is my people. They're fighting for me. My cadre is my ground level soldier. If I, as again the two most powerful men in the universe, can't defend my cadre, can't stand up for them. If they are, it happened with Tupur, it's happening with your cadre, and this is the same mistake Congress makes.
But unhone report mangwai thi.
हाँ तो रिपोर्ट मंगाई कांग्रेस ने भी वही किया बंगाल में खत्म हो गई कांग्रेस
द वे बीजेपी प्रोटेक्टेड पीपल इज कि हमने गवर्नर से रिपोर्ट मंगवाई
द बीजेपी प्रोटेक्ट्स नो वन
दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग
यू डू यू नो अयोध्या में बूथ लेवल वर्कर्स कमिटेड सुइसाइड ऑफ द बीजेपी व्हाई बिकॉज ही वांटेड एडमिशन फॉर हिज वाइफ इन समथिंग in some hospital, he couldn't get it, so he had to sell off all the family jewels and everything.
This is true, I believe this. Mm. I believe
this is
the
same article.
And they did nothing for that guy. BJP, jaise ek nalayak party in looking after its own people, is so zero.
This is true.
Spent so much time in getting people from other parties into the BJP.
25% of the tickets were given to the turncoats.
This is true.
Look at the spokespersons, yaar. Tehsin, you're a spokesperson, unofficial one, but you're a spokesperson.
I'm officially Tehsin.
So
my ex-handle is Tehsin Punala official. So is my Instagram handle.
This is a stroke of genius.
Who's left there in BJP now, other than Sudhanshu Trivedi? I don't think... Shehzad also came from the Congress, Tehsin. Who is the original BJP other than Sudhanshu? I can't think of any. Shazia also came from there.
Gaurav Bhatia came from Samajwadi Party.
Radhika Khera has come from the Congress. Everybody is an import.
Sanju Verma from AAP.
So, yeah, Sanju Verma from AAP.
Congress mukh nahi, Congress
yukh. I'm telling you.
Koi bhi nahi.
And I would keep seeing on TV.
This tickets bhi waise hi to baante hain.
It was an election between Congress Rahul Gandhi and Congress Modi. Congress Rahul Gandhi versus Congress Modi ka election tha ye. Jo Congress se aaya, Modi ji aaye. So what do you want? उस कांग्रेस में उसको एंट्री नहीं आती थी मोदी जी इसको टिकट दे रहे
हैं अगर कोई इनको बताता है राइट इफ एनीबॉडी सेज दैट देन
यू विल बी ट्रोल्ड
नो देन यू आर कांग्रेसी एंड इफ यू टेल द अदर पार्टी यू आर दिस इज अ बीजेपी क्वेश्चन सो आइदर वे यू आर स्क्रूड यू कैन नॉट से एनीथिंग बिकॉज लाइक यस्टरडे आई जस्ट इन सम डिबेट्स आई सेड दैट यू नो यू कैन नॉट मेक फन ऑफ दिस इंडी अलायंस समबडी सेड अ मोटली ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल राइट look at them trying to attempt to make a government. Are so what? That's how everybody behaves, no?
That's their
when
job.
You have a chance of making a government,
why will they
you are a few it? Short, 40 short, 50 short, whatever. You're going to try and do it. You think they're not trying. So I said, you cannot call them this. This motley group of people is what in 2004 made a government. And they used Sonia Gandhi for that. And today they're doing the same thing using her experience. You don't believe in Sonia Gandhi, whatever. Immediately it started off some guy saying, oh, dekho, ye palat gayi hai. This is how she... It's not palat. I have my eyes open. I have
but
a brain.
But you're a journalist. It is your duty to report what is happening. You would be not true to your profession if you didn't report it. No, if you see a change,
you can't you are seeing a
change. And you goddamn have to tell the change. Yeah. But you can't say just because I may have liked A party or B, which you don't have any biases, I will not report the change. It is your duty to report the change. You'd fail if you don't report the change.
So, okay.
Tehsin, the problem is nobody wants to hear the truth.
Nobody wants
to. And nobody and wants to be BJP's told the truth because it's very inconvenient.
Yeah.
But you know, some of the BJP spokespersons...
Jab Chotu mere se bol raha tha.
Nahin, to, Chotu kaun hai? Mujhe Chotu se milna hai. Mujhe Chotu se milna do, Chotu.
We have to make Chotu.
Ah, mera haath tod diya isne.
Please, Chotu ko bulao.
Chotu ko bulao.
ये हाथ का साथ
का साथ है
क्या था वो स्लोगन क्या था
हाथ बदलने का हालात
हाथ बदलने ये हाथ हालात बदलने के लिए
ये हाथ मुझे दे दे अभिजीत ये हाथ मुझे दे दे
दैट वाज सच अ बैड स्लोगन दो आई मीन ऑनेस्टली
बट
हाथ का साथ
हां
इट रियली साउंड्स
या ग्रोस And the first person to notice it was Suhail. Suhail immediately said, who the hell has come up with this line? But
वो जिस जनरेशन से बिलोंग करते हैं, इट्स अंडरस्टैंडेबल।
मैं कुछ नहीं बोलूंगा, बिकॉज़ लास्ट टाइम आई वाज ऑन द शो, वो ट्रेलर में आपने मेरा एक कमेंट यूज़ कर लिया था।
कौन सा यूज़ किया था?
आई रीड हर बुक्स आर टू बी रेड विद वन हैंड।
दूसरा हाथ बदलेगा हालात।
Now I want to come to that important question which people have been asking.
Which is?
Did YouTubers have an influence on this? Dhruvrathi, yeah. Did he have an
influence?
थोड़ा
बहुत तो हुआ होगा यार, ऐसे तो नहीं हो सकता कि बिल्कुल नहीं है, but
no. Abhijit, before you answer, those there were trucks which went along with projectors, and Dhruvrathi's videos were projected out there. So this one thing which I want to say is that, you know, you might diss the content that Ravish or whatever, one echo chamber will diss that, one echo chamber will diss the right-wing content. But the fact is that the right-wing content which was coming out, which is minuscule, was not promoted by the political parties. Whereas the left-wing content, which is ultra-left, which is whether Dhruvrathi or Ravish or whatever, they were shown by the Congress and people like, you know, the India Alliance people, across the length and breadth of those states, yes, where it mattered. So it, yes, Dhruvrathi mattered.
So let me kind of contextualize that.
What matters the is the context, condition of people who
right
have to go and vote.
The right-wing content was organic. The left-wing content was built up. So it's all.
You're talking numbers now.
No, I'm just talking about even the reach.
Why? I mean, you may not believe
in... right-wing content ka aap example dijiye.
Ajit Bharti.
Ajit Bharti. Haan. Totally organic, yaar.
Nahi, but...
Woh khud kehta hai, mujhe koi support nahi kar raha.
Then you're countering your theory. If it is hyped up and it is not organic, then how is it making an impact? And it's not making an impact.
It is making an impact.
Of course, that is the reason why it's making an impact.
You go on repeating it.
Trucks are going.
Yeah.
Trucks are going with that.
Did BJP take Ajit Bharti's content?
Not at all.
They didn't.
Zero.
Every time Ajit Bharti gets demonetized, they don't even support him. Even though we know YouTube and YouTube ka CEO in India, he keeps hanging out at the PMO.
Yeah.
They never raise any of these issues with
them. That's true.
Okay.
But why didn't this YouTubers then work in Madhya Pradesh?
So, one second. So, what I'm saying is, no, that depends on the state units. Na? For example, Dhruvrathi's was taken out in
Bihar.
It was taken out in Haryana. It depends. Look, it depends on the state unit, how efficient they were. But the point is, they tried. Na? Yahan pe to ye wo bhi nahi kiya.
So, I would argue the reverse.
Huh. Yeah, I think it's the reverse.
It is only speaking to those who want to be spoken to. I don't think Dhruvrathi is changing anybody's mind.
I agree.
Mind.
It's the...
No, they are.
No. It's an echo chamber.
In UP, for example, let us talk about UP. Okay? In UP, by all accounts, now we get to know that hawa chal rahi thi, but dusri taraf. The point is that aapne us hawa ke andar, if you were spreading this message, it got traction. If the hawa was not blowing,
exactly,
would this message have got traction?
Just one line.
The same Dhruvrathi and the rest of the bunch were doing the same thing in 2019.
He's right.
Did it have any impact?
It is an echo chamber. Let me give you a very practical example. I have two Instagram accounts. One is an official account, one is an unofficial account. No. In my official account, I follow Rahul Gandhi, Congress, all of that, right? What I support.
मिस्टर डोवल का भाई है मेरे को लगता है.
सुनिए ना, सुनिए.
हम सारे करते हैं यार,
सारे करते
हैं. दो दो विल नॉट, दो ट्विटर अकाउंट लेट यू हैव, दे विल नॉट गिव यू एक्सेस. So you have to do it.
सुनिए ना, सो इन माय official account is all the liberals, congress, etc. My official account proved congress was winning. My second account, which nobody knows about, where I follow prime minister Amit Shah, everything, was showing me BJP is winning. It is an echo chamber. Right. The same account on two phones, the same person's account on two phones, depending on whom I'm following, is showing me 100% Modi is winning 400 par. Yahan pe bata raha tha 295.
Tehsin, whether these things have an impact or not, I don't know whether I'm slightly older than you, so my generation, when we got out of college, there were these cassettes which came out with Sadhvi Ritambara speeches. Yeah. If you heard that, to me, it was frightening to me.
Yeah, it was.
But there were so many people I knew who got so totally influenced. To me, it turned me the other way. But to many of my cousins and relatives and friends, they turned very, very right wing. So it depends on how it impacts you, but it impacts you in some way.
But now the $1 million or $1 billion question. Okay. You look at the numbers, you look at the hits, the eyeballs. Has it irreversibly shifted towards YouTube, or is legacy media or even non-legacy media still of some relevance?
I think legacy media pe questions hai. I'll tell you why. Serious questions.
Reach nahi hai
unki. I am somewhere in legacy media. When I did the interview with Mr. Modi...
Are you reading newspapers, any of you?
I do.
A bit. I read Times of India
You don't. Tehsin?
I don't.
Okay, so I...
15 years ago, it would have been...
I read it because it's my work too, right?
No, I read.
So I would read that to see where have I missed, where is my agency missed, what should I be focusing on for my print section. I watch television news, not television debates, though I come on debates, but just to see what I should cover. But just to come back to whether it's becoming irrelevant or not, the point is you see the numbers today.
It's crazy. I mean,
social media has much more numbers than television has, right? One point. The second point I want to make is that when I interviewed Mr. Modi, that was the first interview that he gave television. After that, he's given 60 television and newspapers and all. In the first interview, I did ask him, is this election a mere formality? Because that's what people are saying. Now, very cleverly, the trollers have cut out that part, right? But the point is, at the start of the election, that is what it seemed. That, you know, he's going to win anyway.
Yeah.
Everybody was saying that. All the television channels were saying that.
It was a done deal.
But it was not on the ground. So I, as media, have to rethink about how I do the questioning now. Because I was also taken in by that wave that, are ye to jeetne hi wale hai, bas number ka farak hai.
No, but let me look at your question another way. Look at your question another way. Somebody as a journalist, you're asking the Prime Minister who's expected to win, do you still think it's a done deal? Maybe it's not, and maybe you do believe it's not. It's your job, again, to ask a question. Why are you giving into what the trollers are putting by clipping a clip? You could have easily thought maybe it's not a done deal. Maybe the BJP or the Prime Minister is being overconfident. Why are you allowing the trollers to control what you actually thought? As a journalist, it is a very legitimate question to ask somebody who's the favourite to win. Is it a done deal?
If he gives me an opportunity, would I not ask him that, are you the Prime Minister candidate?
Exactly.
Does that
make you a troller?
Yeah. Isn't it available to you all the time to be Prime Minister candidate?
We take it too seriously, the opinions that
what social media is saying.
YouTube ka ek bahut bada factor hai ki they build a community around it. They have a base, and sooner than later, they can't disappoint that base.
Yeah.
So, Ravish will never say anything that is going to antagonize its
base. Dekho, aise hai, but look, this is what happened with the legacy media.
Sushant, I'm going to come to you about Pakistanis. Pakistanis are making content about India because they're making money on YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah.
True. They are now making content about Indian elections. Bhai, tum apne mulk ka dekha hai tumne? Even the newspapers like New York Times, Washington Post, the entire model is now write something negative about India because Indians are going to click on negative news.
And they're going to lambast you also.
Yeah, and they're going to make money with those clicks.
Yeah.
So this is
I think Abhijit says, na, never retweet. Just take a
screenshot
and then do it. Paisa nahi milega.
I will never, every time I see a Dhruv Rathi video or a Ravish video, if it comes up, I never search for them. But if it comes up on my, this thing, I immediately report it.
Why do you report it?
Because it has to be done. I very specifically said don't recommend it to
me. How democratic?
No. That it shouldn't come up on my timeline if I don't want to see it.
So how do you, why, what is it? Reporting is because it's either untrue or it's abusive.
Yeah,
why
he feels reporting it is untrue.
It is untrue.
He feels it's lies. He's not banning it for everyone
now
else.
Now imagine what YouTube does. Even when I say don't recommend this channel, it brings it up.
YouTube guy is okay. The PMO's favorite.
The YouTube guy is the PMO's
favorite. I'm honestly telling you this.
Who is this YouTube guy?
See, I can't deal with defamations like
this. His Chotu will tell you.
Chotu bata
dega. Now, what happens is, with all these other guys, because they thrive off engagement, I will only take photos and put it up and quote it. Yeah. And I refuse to actually even answering anybody. Even for Gali Galoch. As you know, I'm Gali Das, younger brother of Gali Das. What Kali Das was to Sanskrit literature, I am to Gali's. My Gali's are more profound than Abhigyana Shakuntalam and things like that. So please, follow Gali.
Achha, is the Sanatan debate over? Was it only for election? That first two rounds, so long as DMK was in play, it became such a big thing. Is the Sanatan Rao over?
No, they're now encouraged by the results. They're going to act on it. I think
and
you're going
BJP
to see a lot of
helpless.
And BJP will do nothing.
What will BJP do?
They will do nothing.
They won't fight on the streets.
Yeah.
That only Manish Tiwari was ready to do.
They don't fight the massive majority. They did nothing.
Winston Churchill.
जब majority था तब कुछ नहीं किया तो अब minority है तो क्या करेंगे boss?
और काशी विश्वनाथ इज आल्सो
इवन दो व्हेन यू आर इन अ माइनॉरिटी गवर्नमेंट लाइक दिस देयर इज अ ग्रेटर इंसेंटिव टू यू फॉर यू टू गो हार्ड बिकॉज़ यू हैव
फॉर दैट यू नीड टू बी एबल टू प्रोटेक्ट योर कार्ड
अल्टीमेटली देखो ना
मेरी बात सुनो द बॉटम लाइन इज सो हियर इज द थिंग And this is one thing you have to give to the Congress party, right?
Congress ne kya kiya?
Yaar, Congress party has always protected its cadres, whatever cadres, always.
You in, and I'll tell you something. Not made him spokesperson.
No, I don't want to be. Tehsin.
One second. So sorry. Why would I want to be in the company of them when I am doing much better on my own? Why?
Okay, now listen. So
their best spokesperson is Shehzad, who's in the BJP.
You know, in the worst. एक मिनट सुनो
तेरे चरण किधर है
अच्छा
चरण
मंदन यार डाइवर्ट मत
सॉरी चरण मंदन
द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द कांग्रेस एंड द बीजेपी वाज दैट इवन इन द कांग्रेस पार्टी व्हेन गाइस वर फाइटिंग अगेंस्ट ईच अदर ठीक है सो सपोजिंग यू एंड आई वर इन द कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड वी आर कंपीटिंग फॉर अ पोजीशन एंड वी आर अंडरकटिंग ईच अदर अगर इफ यू केम टू मी फॉर सम वर्क
वो कर देते
दे वुड ऑलवेज डू इट
वो कांग्रेस का कल्चर
ओके इन द बीजेपी देयर इज अ die hard worker of yours, it's like that guy, that booth level guy, you will not do it. And this happened, I remember this.
ये बहुत पहले की बात नहीं
चलती. देखो ये वाजपेयी जी के टाइम की बात है. There was when मुरली मनोहर जोशी was the HRD minister. I remember a particular case which a bureaucrat friend of mine had told me. Some woman who was a big supporter of this, Kendriya Vidyalaya, got posted out. Her husband was a supporter. She got posted from Delhi to Guwahati. And she said, listen, you are posting me to Guwahati. My family is out here. How will I... I can't do this. The rules say this. Right? Rule book says this. Bloody, the rule book does not say this when it apne upar apply
hota. I'll tell you one. Another incident was when there was serious trouble between the Akalis and the BJP during Vajpayee's term. And at that time, the Akalis had... a serious issue. I don't want to get into the complication of that. It was about the creation of Uttarakhand, Uttaranchal. At that time, they were fighting over one place.
Udham Singh Nagar.
So, Udham Singh Nagar. Do you remember the protests and all that? And when the Akalis went to Advani ji and Vajpayee ji, they just said, sab kuch niyam anusar hoga.
See, going by the rule book, I know politicians themselves do not apply the same rules, but wo fir bhi theek hai. Lekin when 100 of your workers are butchered in Bengal
so I was going to come to that.
Forget about that. You don't even stand up for them.
This is exactly what I was going to say. Yeah. So, for example, in Tamil Nadu, you've got your 10% vote. This is the time for you to build up. Mm. And you have to be street warriors on this, right? You have to be out on the street. But you know that the guys sitting either in Chennai or in Delhi are not going to do jack shit for you, right?
And for the guys are out for Annamalai.
When the pogrom started in Bengal, after the election, what prevented these guys from saying that we are going to impose president's rule because the state of law and order has broken down?
Yeah. Hmm. Hmm.
It had broken down.
But it was in the rule book.
The governor didn't send a report.
Hmm. And party is saying ki, report.
Now, there was. Now, let's see who the BJP stands up for. There was one absolute third rate fellow who recently got arrested by some police. And all the BJP leaders were tweeting for him. Okay. He comes out and he makes a video which thunk the BJP. He said, Dekho, dono party corrupt hain. BJP corrupt hai, par wo pro Hindu hai. और कांग्रेस करप्ट है पर वो एंटी हिंदू है तो क्या बेहतर नहीं है अगर हम प्रो हिंदू करप्शन के लिए वोट करें
ये कौन था
ये
भीको मात्रे
ओके आई मीन हिज स्यूडोनिम इज भीको मात्रे
दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ टू बिट दियाज दे स्टैंड अप फॉर तो भूख तो
यू थिंक दिस
यू डिजर्व भीको मात्रे एंड ही डिजर्व्स यू
This is another thing.
You see, the question, Smita, out here is not that BJP is not standing up for them. What is the psyche that makes them not stand up for their work? What is the psyche? Have we answered that question?
I'll answer the question.
This is the typical problem of the Hindu society. कि मेरा अपना घर साफ रहे
एक सेकेंड
कूड़ा व्यवहार
यू सी ममता वो भी हिंदू ही है
बीजेपी डिस्पाइट टू ओवरवेलमिंग मेजोरिटी बिलीव्स इट्स एन ऑपोजिशन एंड विल एक्ट लाइक एन ऑपोजिशन कांग्रेस विद
50 ये तो उल्टा कह रहा है भाई
विक्टिम कार्ड
ये उल्टा कह रहा है
नहीं 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 विक्टिम कार्ड वो कर रहे हैं ये कर रहे हैं आप सरकार में हो आप करो
बीजेपी की एटीट्यूड इज इफ यू हेल्प मी तुम्हारा सौभाग्य है डोंट एक्सपेक्ट एनीथिंग
तुमको भला मिलेगा तुमको भला मिलेगा
द डेथ ऑफ दैट अयोध्या बूथ लेवल वर्कर इज इनएक्सक्यूजेबल आई होप दैट डेथ stains the karma of every single BJP leader who went to Ayodhya.
Achha, I have this data now here about when you were talking about Dhruv Rathi and all. Now, this is what it is. This is the top, among the top now, those who are doing, number 3 pe Abhisar Sharma, number 4 pe Ravish Kumar official, number 5 pe Dhruv Rathi. Ajit Anjum is 11, Sakshi Joshi is 14, 15 is Punya Prasun. There is no right wing here at all.
Punya Prasun is that Krantikari guy.
Haan, Krantikari guy. Yeh sara jo hai,
aap
jo count kar rahe ho, everything comes. And you know where Jaipur Dialogues comes? 28.
In the first 20...
He comes at 28 number.
The first 27 is all this side.
Yeah. So
what is this new DB Live?
This is not Dainik Bhaskar. This is DB Live.
It's got very popular.
What I'm saying is that for those who don't have this paper, you look at this. So all these, this is what it is, the commentators. So how are they getting the numbers? I don't know whether they're boosting numbers. Vaad is number 22.
Vaad is 22. Is the highest.
Yeah.
No, it's not the highest.
They're not even there.
Arihant, yeah.
Look at the whole top.
It's crazy. 2%.
It's crazy.
Vaad is 2%.
So you tell me in 10 years, BJP, with its supposedly technological prowess,
has not been able to deal with an ecosystem or promote an ecosystem to put its point of view.
Now, what explains? Do they believe that we have the legacy media, we don't need to go for this? So,
do they treat the legacy media well?
No.
Arnab ka dekha kya kiya?
Kya kiya?
No.
Jail mein tha. What did they do to help him?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So,
court nahi bail diya, na?
Yeah, so, if... What I'm trying to say is the legacy media then fooled the BJP with their exit polls. Mm-hmm. That's all I can say. If the exit polls, all of them were wrong, and they promoted this exit poll that our exit poll is the best,
why would somebody want to rig an exit poll?
I don't know.
It doesn't make sense. I'm
telling you the stock market.
See, they weren't rigged, yaar. The exit polls weren't rigged.
No, that's what I'm saying.
You look at the percentages, they were completely, it clearly showed in the percentages. The issue was extrapolating the percentages seat by seat by seat. That was the real issue.
I think they were absolute rubbish. I will never again go on a debate based on an exit poll or an opinion.
But it's very
poll.
Funny.
We have done this every time.
No, I got it wrong.
Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, abhi hua hai. Every exit poll was predicting BJP.
I'm done with
it.
Including you.
I followed ETG.
Too funny, because today exit poll comes out and we look at the exit poll results and we wax eloquent and we know why the exit poll is making one party win. Okay. 3 days later, the result is completely overturned and we are again waxing eloquent.
Why the other party?
Although, on the result day, many of my tweets were in drafts.
But you still have a 3-day gap. Imagine this. Once again,
Even gone into Maharashtra, which is going to polls 3 months from now.
And so we'll go 3 months from now.
We need to discuss Haryana, Maharashtra, BMC polls.
So सारे इकट्ठे होंगे ना polls. तो अगले podcast में कर लेंगे.
तो वो we will do before that so that we have egg on us. When the results come out.
But the greatest tragedy that happened was in this entire polling season, nobody got to see my interpretive dance.
He was going to come as a naked peacock or something.
But that was only if
What do you mean by naked peacock? Is there
he's going to be naked with peacock feathers all over him.
What is a naked peacock?
This has to go. I'm telling you. Will no more dance.
But where would the peacock feathers be on the backside of there?
Whatever makes him happy, whatever tickles him.
Gross. You were going to do a peacock dance. Adik.
Abhi kar de.
You know, I was in Israel with this.
Ude, peacock ka haat aise nahi hota. Peacock ka haat yun hota hai.
I was in Israel with this. With this TV actor, Madhura Desai. And she comes in this serial called Nagin and she plays Ichhadari Mor. Now I knew there was
Ichhadari Nagin.
No, there is Ichhadari Nagin. I didn't know there was an Ichhadari Mor. She comes as Ichhadari Mor.
Good Lord. To kill the Nag. Because peacock can kill the...
Yes.
Oh, okay. It's more interesting than being an Ichhadari mongoose, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
To fight the snake. But how would you do that? Dikha mereko. Ichhadari Mor.
Ichhadari Mor. Okay. So Ichhadari Nagin would be like this. Na 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 na. Now Ichhadari Mor is like this.
Wait. How do you catch a mor?
It's a crime to do that.
You can't catch a mor.
Like other prime minister. इसको रिकॉर्ड करो
उसको मोर को खिला रहे
हैं प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोर को खिला रहे थे हो गया नो मोर दिस हैज टू गो ऑन
तो इच्छाधारी मोर ऐसे होगा तान ना ना तान ना 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 दिल है तेरा दीवाना
मित्रों
Hey, Bhagwan.
Ye dil mange mor. Ye dil mange mor.
But why that? Israel? That just suddenly...
Because she's half Jewish. She lost family on 7th October.
Oh, my God.
Mm. So, you know that thing where mother and father were killed in the car and the IDF rescues the two kids from the back of the car? That was her family. That the mother who was killed was her first cousin who was Indian Jewish.
Oh, God.
Mm.
No, I haven't met her recently, though. I met her last at a...
We are actually doing a podcast without mentioning Ravina Tandon.
Yeah. But we did now. We just did now. You know she was mobbed?
Yeah.
And that was terrible.
And fake. Completely fake.
And completely fake. And I'm glad those CCTV
Yeah.
And imagine these guys making that up.
Kuch hua
uske baad. This is a learning.
No, no, you know the police did. The police said, nahi, kisi ka kuch nahi ho gaya. It was a misunderstanding. They should have charged those guys for inciting violence.
Yeah. But there was CCTV. We need a dash cam. All of us should have a dash cam.
मेरे तो कोई अगर गाड़ी वाड़ी मार दे मैं तो लड़ाई नहीं करता मतलब तू जा यार मैंने कुछ देना है तो मेरे को बता देना मैं दे दूंगा because there's no point.
Yeah.
No, no. Have you seen the clip yesterday? There was a swimming pool in Meerut.
You are?
No.
There's a swimming pool in Meerut and there's an argument between two people. And there is this, just an argument and suddenly one of these guys pulls out a gun and shoots this guy in the head and you can see his little kid
just watching it.
And the wife running and
it's just so violent.
It's just gone crazy.
Mirrored, it seems.
Mirrored.
Yeah, but come on. But I'm seeing yesterday. This lack of tolerance.
I got a call saying that aapne jo wo gun license ke liye apply kiya hai, uske bare mein details puchna. I was like, मैंने कोई नहीं अप्लाई किया भाई और सडनली आउट ऑफ द ब्लू यू नो आपका एड्रेस ये है क्या आई सेड हाँ एड्रेस ये है फोन आपका ही है आई सेड हाँ फोन मेरा है
पर मैंने कोई नहीं टू रैंडम पीपल
What?
How do you know
that somebody in the house applied for it? No.
For with my phone number.
No, no, ऐसे थोड़ी.
No, no. And how do you know this is actually a cop? Why are you giving your data to random people? Don't. If it is a cop, they should send an official email from the government.
No, I said नहीं है. I said नहीं चाहिए. मेरा तो नहीं.
But you're confirming your address and your number. No? Huh. Never do that.
Okay.
Data protection number, never give out your thing. They want to confirm then. How do you know they'll misuse the data with AI today available with darknet?
No, but you look, you see, even in this day and age, that the whole Pune thing,
yeah.
The mother, now today it was confirmed that the mother switched the blood sample.
Yeah.
What is happening here?
I know them.
The car.
I know them. Vishal and Shiva. I know them. Terrible
know
thing.
Know whom?
I know the
family. The family.
Yeah, terrible.
You've been following that quite a lot, the Pune accident.
I follow all accidents very carefully. You know why? Because accidents and who gets away with it and who gets punished are the clearest revealer. They're the most tangible revealer of power, the abuse of power and the abuse of the justice system.
True.
This was an outrageous, in-your-face violation of the justice system. But because of that, I have been tracking these violations of the justice system for so long now. I've just lost mere memory mein nahi rehta ki main kya sab track kar raha tha.
Yeah.
It is so blatant, boss, ki they get away with murder. If you are drunk and you kill someone, it is murder. It is not rash driving. Rash driving is where you have your senses, you are not inebriated, you are driving, over-speeding and you kill somebody. When you are drunk, it is murder because you have crossed the threshold of intent.
Drunk driving
should be... But as soon as that incident happened, within a few hours, I tweeted and several other people tweeted that either the driver will come or it will be proven that it was Maruti. It was not a Porsche. It was not... I mean, it will happen.
Let's
some rich lawyer will say that it was not him. And sure enough, it happened, yaar. मतलब अगर वो BMW केस हमारे मेमोरी से गया नहीं है अभी तक दिस इज व्हाट यू नो आई मीन इट्स टेरिफाइंग एनीवे
यू नो देयर इज अ मच वर्स केस दैट समबडी ब्रॉट अप इन दिस थिंग इट इज दी आई थिंक व्हाट इज दिस गाय योगेश देयर इज दिस फेलो कॉल्ड योगेश हु वाज किल्ड बाय अ कार ड्रिवन बाय अ रिच किड देयर इज CCTV फुटेज of the rich kid coming out of the driving seat, seeing kya sab hua, and the police have covered up the evidence and they're saying there is no CCTV footage.
So, you know, even in this Pune case, I have to tell you this, now Pune police have gone berserk on nightclubs, shut everything down, which I have no problem with, they can shut down. For all these times, these nightclubs and lounges ran because the police take hafta. The police are hand in glove and the excise department.
I sent you the hafta sheet. I sent you the hafta sheet of the Pune police. Now what? They even have a printed sheet on which...
That's the reason. So I was in the night... So when I was a teenager, I got into nightclub business. And this is the reason why I left this business. So I ran the most successful nightclubs in Pune. But the reason, one day, I just got up and I left this. I got up a morning and said, I cannot do this anymore. Is the way the police manipulates the system. You are subservient and working for the police. All of this happens because the police makes money. You know, in a and I want, just once again, Anand, so in a restaurant business, the restaurant owner or the investor, the government's your partner. The government's also unofficially your partner. So you pay 30% income tax, 18% other taxes. You have no input credit in restaurants now. So so your taxes go, but you pay GST. So you end up paying 50%. Plus you play these bribes. The government makes 60, 65%, 70%. And now how do I cover up the 70%? So you say, boss, I'll turn a blind eye. You can serve the underage guy. Why don't you make the business official and allow for strict measures so somebody who's below 25 is not served as by the law? Because you want to make money, the police, so they're allowing these 16-year-olds in, and then it's become a racket. So it is so terrible, and now you shut all the lounges down. So what about those people who are working there?
So it's like this article, which says that you can reduce the burden on victims where officials are accepting bribes in EMIs.
My God.
So, tumko agar 2 lakh bribe dena hai and you don't have 2 lakhs, you can give
per month. This is the Gujarat thing.
But and it's, I believe
the Yogesh episode is in Nagpur. It's Jaipur police.
He was saying something. Huh?
But BJP ruled state, Jaipur police.
To bring it into the larger discussion, will we have any
judicial
police
reforms?
Or judicial reforms?
Yeah, that's what I'm worried. That
yeah, dekho meri baat suno. When under
concluding
when,
remarks, huh?
When Nitin Gadkari brought in that new motor vehicles law and said that if you are caught drunk driving, there will be a fine of $25,000. What happened? Socialism took over. That there is a poor fellow. If the bastard is a poor fellow, why is he drinking and driving?
Why is he drinking?
Why is he drinking? Where is this written?
So there is an actual incentive.
You can be poor, you can be drinking
and commit a crime.
Commit a crime and you'll be let go.
You know the
same thing. Do you know the official standard?
Yeah. So the official standard is if a car hits a scooter, it is the car's fault. Why is it the car's fault? If the scooter is the one doing the error, it should be the scooter's fault.
So now this new laws which are coming. So this is what I'm wondering, whether when you have a minority government.
Keep your fingers crossed that you have never anything to do with the government
or the police,
or the judicial system.
Yeah.
That you are completely out of
it. We are all in some way or the other. Kabhi na kabhi to zarurat.
Yaar, mere ko dekho pata hai, 2.5 saal se mere bijli ka bill average pe aa raha tha. Dhakke kha kha ke main pagal ho gaya.
Average.
Koi kaam nahi hua. Finally, somebody helped me out. Average pe. They're just giving me a random bill.
Achha, achha.
It turned out that we had paid 50-60,000 bucks extra to the electricity department. So that was resolved in December. Since December, it's May now, I've still not got a bill.
And again, it'll get the one-time big thing.
Cumulative aega fir.
So you know, but it's crazy, yeah.
The same thing happened.
And this is Haryana. So tell me something, if tomorrow, okay, I can still manage, right?
Yeah.
Somebody who can't, when the election time comes, he'll say, I'm going to give you, all you guys, a kick on your backs and because I'm angry with you, I'll bring in somebody, even if I don't
agree
with
you. Why are you paying? Na? Haryana mein free hona chahiye na? Ki bijli free. Now that's going to happen, everything has to be free.
No, hamare liye nahi hai na.
Hum log khatam karte hain aaj ke liye. And let's reconnect before the next assembly.
After the election, because otherwise I don't want to go on my face.
So closing
closing remarks.
Closing remarks. This entire election season did not see one of my interpretive dances. To end where
he was going to do the more dance.
Sushant Papa left off. Do you want to see an electricity interpretive dance?
Yes, please.
Okay. No, I don't.
No. I haven't concluded my introductory remarks.
He wants to charge us up with his electricity.
Yes. I want to do the international dance of electricity.
Electricity.
Are we supposed to be shocked?
So.
He suddenly come up with this.
Are we supposed to be shocked?
Yeah, it's extemporizing. Huh. Okay. And.
Captive audience.
Yes. Yeah. This is electricity. Flowing through and through.
तेरे से गंदा dancer मैंने आज तक नहीं देखा.
चुप. तू जलता है मेरे से मोटू. चुप बैठ.
मुझे बोल रहा है मोटू.
ये 18 months.
ये तेरे बच्चे हैं.
Oh God.
The
imagery of how that happened. बचा लो भगवान.
Wipe it off.
पूरा.
अच्छा चलो cut. चलो अब तेरी बारी. बस कर यार.
You want me to do the electricity dance?
Beware the danger of such beauty. Because if you touch it.
Buffoonery. Achha, baith ja.
I have a multifaceted personality.
Okay, fine.
Now you have a well rounded personality.
You have a personality.
Well rounded personality.
Literally.
जलता है बदन वाला डांस भी करता
जलता है
मोटे तो पापा शर्म करो मैं तुम्हारा बेटा हूँ कौन लाई है तुम्हारे घर
सन इन लॉ में लाई कैसे यू आर द गर्ल
ओके अब तहसील
पापा जी पहले पढ़ो
You made a devastating revelation once on Big Boss.
Yeah.
This comes very close to
no,
that.
No, we are not going into that one. Please. Okay.
For everyone, one second. This is only a joke. None of it is true. Please don't clap.
He's the father of my children.
It is biologically not possible.
No, he's the father.
Don't talk about biological.
Him. 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 Ha. XXXY chromosome thing.
No. My reference was to something else.
The election related biological.
Biological.
अच्छा बोल ना
हाँ बोल ना यार
कंक्लूडिंग रिमार्क सोचा हुआ है कुछ
नहीं आई कम इन द एंड
ही कम इन द एंड अभी
सोच रहा
है अभी मेरा व्हाट डू यू माय डी इज माय ग्लोटिंग
व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज गोना हैपन इन द नेक्स्ट फ्यू डेज
आई विल टेल यू दिस वुड बी लाइक यूपीए 1 दिस वुड बी अ स्टेबल गवर्नमेंट दिस वुड नॉट डू एनीथिंग कंटेंशियस मोदी विल नॉट टच एनीथिंग रिगार्डिंग हिंदू इंटरेस्ट
यूपीए 1 डिड न्यूक्लियर डील ब्रो
या
एट द एंड फैग एंड
एंड स्टेक द गवर्नमेंट
Absolutely, it'll be good for the country.
Did they jibe at me?
Why?
Fag end.
Okay. He didn't say faggot end. He just said fag end.
Fag is short for faggot.
Nahin, no, fag is no, cigarette fag is also. Hamare bete generation mein ha.
End of the fag.
It was a homophobic jibe at me after.
Arey chalna. Arey yar.
Isne bhi homophobic.
Bol please. Please continue.
So it will be good for the economy. I don't think Modi will be blackmailed because he's not going to touch any issue, which is going to be contentious. So it'll be like a stable UPA 1 government, and in the long run, economically, it'd be very good for the country. Chandrababu Naidu, I think he should get into the economic.
He's
ministry.
A reforms oriented guy.
Totally reforms oriented guy. He got kicked out because he wanted a lot of reforms.
Correct.
So Modi is more of a status quoist than Chandrababu Naidu. So and as far as social thing is concerned, he will listen to Nitish because anyway Modi has not done anything for the Hindu, removing Hindu discrimination. He won't touch it.
Bringing
now.
Babu and Nitish into the government is not a negative in my opinion. I just feel that they are good for the country. They're good for the party. I mean for the NDA. That's what is my opinion.
But I think what matters in the next 5 years. Is the economy.
But 5 years chalega ya will there be midterm?
100%.
There are lots of people saying that Modi might dissolve it after the next election.
So,
after
2 years ago, what did I say? Somebody asked me and jocularly I gave out the list of prime ministers till 2049. And I said 2026 would Amit Shah come. I think it might be.
So by dissolving
Modi turns 75 or after 2 years,
are saying even from the BJP is that if the coalition partners get pesky, then Modi at some point of time, maybe after the Maharashtra elections or after a couple of elections, wait for another year. If they get too pesky, then dissolve it and go for elections again.
He doesn't have a lot of pesky. Even if they do constitutionally, he can't dissolve it because then those same people who've got pesky will go with the India Alliance. It's only 232 to 95.
Constitutionally, he can dissolve
Let me just put my point.
Politically, he may not. That's different.
I'm talking constitutionally. There are people who are pesky decide to go that side, the president is duty bound to call the second highest.
Not
until a vote of no confidence has been moved.
Which is why if they're that side and they call for
no confidence. The moment he sees them going that side, he can go to the president.
And he goes to the president, he can't dissolve parliament. The president has duty bound to call the other.
No.
President can't dissolve.
1 second. As long as the man has a majority in the house,
that's true.
Correct.
The president is duty bound to dissolve the house.
Exactly. If those people go and say no, he doesn't have the majority, have you proved
where is this written?
And therefore they want to know confidence.
Where is it proved that he doesn't have the majority? So that is, listen, you don't hear me. If they have moved a no confidence motion,
he cannot advise dissolution of the house.
Then he has to face it.
Then he has to face it.
If he says, I am dissolving the house, how the opposition goes and shows that the number of
presidents is doing it. So abdicating,
majority of government can dissolve the house at any time.
No, the president
is wrong. I am predicting Modi leaving in 2026 and becoming the president in 2029.
Which you had said earlier.
No.
I think what, 2026 okay, so I, kuch hoga. I
so,
don't know what.
Maybe so I think for me, for my concluding remarks are, number one, end the culture of sycophancy. It's disastrous. Mm. Okay? It stops all the feedback coming to you. Mm. And people then tend to give you, what they think you want to hear. Mm. What I've heard is that he's open to listening to other people, but people just want to give him what they think he wants to hear. Mm. End the culture of sycophancy. Stop drinking your own Kool-Aid.
Mm.
End that stuff, right? I think there will be some economic reforms. There should be. There will be greater welfareism.
Mm.
I don't see... I hope there is something for the middle classes. I'm not so sure of it.
Mm.
I see very torrid times internationally, both from our so-called friends as well as from our enemies.
Mm.
So I see... big challenges coming on the national security front, not only in terms of the traditional threats, but also the non-traditional threats which we've spoken about. I don't think there'll be any judicial reforms. I don't think there'll be any other...
It's economy now, all the way.
Yeah.
Thoda bahut economy
mein karenge,
but will the economy be able to take off? And this is the 100%. this is the tragedy. Finally, I don't.
My prediction.
Mm. So now there is an election next year, for example, in Bihar. How does that election go? If the BJP wins that election along with JDU, then this government becomes much more stable.
There's Maharashtra.
They are likely to lose. Haryana, they are likely to lose.
Yeah.
Unless they can change something, which I don't think they can, because they've just gotten a new chief minister in Haryana, who's neither here nor there.
Delhi. So Delhi, we haven't discussed.
So Smita, Delhi, we haven't discussed.
52 of assembly seats were won by BJP in terms of.
So pichli baari bhi to jeete the, uske agle saal
wo haare the. They lose that.
Okay, I need from you concluding remarks.
No, but I'm not finished.
Okay, you prepare for it because I want to come end with Sharad Pawar is not over, Uddhav Thackeray is not over this election show.
So the other thing is I don't see Modi saying I'm going to hang up my boots at 75.
Hmm.
That was something meant for somebody else, not for him, right? I wouldn't be surprised if he says that to recoup my reputation, I will go in the 29 election, assuming that an election is in 29, win that election and set a new record.
Hmm.
He could very well do that.
Hmm.
Who will be his
successor?
I think that is something you can't... And that's the third big lesson. Apart from Kool-Aid, apart from sycophancy, please stop railroading. There are some decisions which have to come top-down.
Hmm.
But have a culture of consultation, which this election probably will throw up.
And preparing people for it. Whether it's not necessary.
Listen, you can't diss a man like Yogi, who also is catching the imagination of a lot of the core constituents.
Mm. Yeah.
Right? Yogi might not have the same sophistication, which even Mr. Modi did not have 20 years back. Yeah, right? Yeah. But Yogi is somebody who strikes a chord. Incorruptible, has no family issues. Yeah, no person who is going to bequeath.
Age dikha raha hai, issues.
But
हमारे जमाने में इश्यू बोलते थे ना जैसे वाइफ को मिसेस बोलते थे आपकी मिसेस नहीं आई तो वही वाला है
अलायंस आई वेंट टू अ गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट एंड आई वाज डू यू हैव इश्यूज आई सेड नो
डू यू सीक अलायंस
डू
यू सीक अलायंस
आई स्वेयर आई हैड नो आइडिया
यू डू सीक अलायंस
वाज सो पैथेटिक आई वाज
यू डोंट सीक अलायंस
अच्छा वो
हां डू यू सीक अलायंस
बच्चों के लिए इट्स
सीक अलायंस अच्छा कंक्लूडिंग रिमार्क्स
सो I think that this election has shown that democracy is well and truly alive in our country.
And EVMs work.
EVMs.
And every single political party must bow down to the people. No one can take the people of India for granted.
Agreed.
The first three words of our constitution are we the people. So one thing that spooked a lot of people is when Modi ji said for 400 plus, we're going to make civilizational changes for the next 1,000 years. Now it's become that those elected are here to serve we the people. They're no longer masters of our destiny. They're servants of our destiny. And I think like you rightly said, CA or whatever that they want to bring in will have to be a consultative process. So you'll never have another prime minister coming in, at least for the next 5 years, at 8 p.m. saying 4 hours later, your notes aren't
aren't working, or 4 hours later there's a lockdown. That won't happen, which is good. On the flip side, I do think the economy will pick up. As much as I dislike the BJP politically, I want India to progress. So I think this is a great opportunity for India to be a great opposition, the India Alliance, to be a great opposition, because the country must do well. Catch the right issues, don't fight on the wrong issues, and hopefully India will do well, and it should
and
do
change
well.
Change your advisors.
Because India's time is now under the sun. The next
change your advisors.
Years, yeah, they could take me.
Yeah, I'm talking about the I would.
How did they get Sharad Pawar and Uddhav Thackeray so wrong? That media also said that this is over for Sharad Pawar. I mean, that's one person like a phoenix. Phoenix rises once. This guy rises again and again from the ashes.
So I agree on Sharad Pawar. I disagree on Uddhav Thackeray, as much as it's unpopular. Uddhav Thackeray and the Shiv Sena one, because the Congress votes, that's the Uddhav Thackeray faction. Uddhav Thackeray, yes, there is sympathy amongst the elite, the English, the Mumbai speaking. He isn't a mass leader. It is the Congress that has done so phenomenally well in Maharashtra.
You're saying he's going to join Modi.
And I'll just finish. The Congress, and I want everyone to understand, the Congress was born in Maharashtra. It was born in Pune because the plague was born in Bombay. The Congress is a Maharashtra party. At its worst state, the Congress is the biggest party in Maharashtra in two areas of Maharashtra, Vidarbha and Western Maharashtra. So BJP and Congress are the biggest parties. The strength of the Congress, even I often tell, you don't know how strong the Congress in Maharashtra. And this was the vote for the Congress. Along with that, the Shiv Sena came. Sharad Pawar, yes, he has the Maratha vote and the Muslim vote because the Congress gets it. But it is Sharad Pawar's rise, yes, but it's the Congress, not so much Uddhav Thackeray.
Okay. So shall we end on that? Thank you so
Thank
much,
you
gentlemen. So we meet before
Thank
the Maharashtra
you.
Election. After the
Maharashtra.
And we end rejecting food.
No, because we are all wiser after an election, not before an election.
Okay. That's what we said yesterday.
Shall we end with the Ichhadari Mohr dance?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, enough of this dancing, honestly.
Okay, Ichhadari Mohr toh humne record kar liya.
We recorded that.
Recorded. While
did you get
Anand
the comments? More.
Okay, thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for watching or listening to this edition of the ANI podcast with Smita Prakash. Do like or subscribe on whichever channel you have seen this or heard this. Namaste, Jai Hind. Click here to watch the previous episodes.